That's all we like.
That's a good intro, man. Yes.
Watch John Cena. Yes.
Fuck yeah, Cena. He can ball it down.
What the hell happened? Oh my God, I spazzed.
What? All right, what's going on, ladies and gentlemen? We are live for, well, not live, but well, kind of, once, okay, you know, it's going to be premiered. But anyways, as we speak, so, Asylum Show episode 248.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We got
240 fries.
Fries. Get your fries.
Yeah, so there's going to be plenty of Spider-Men and
yes,
pro wrestling.
And holding it down.
Oh, the artist formerly known as Black Panther. Cool.
Yep, so. All right, let's see what we got. All right, so we got our WWE segment as usual. We got the Owen Hart tournament.
Okay.
Yeah, Owen Hart, yeah. Kick the leg out of that motherfucking leg.
Then we got Hannibal Spike.
Enough is enough, and it's time for a change.
The fuck?
Who the fuck played Shawn Michaels?
You mean Hogan?
The fuck?
Yeah,
brother. Remember my fucking theme.
All right.
We got Kimo Rollins in the house. Thanks. It's awesome.
We got Andrew Garfield as a topic.
Yeah.
No.
Aaron and John Cena. Yeah.
Never heard of her.
Okay, you know what? Okay, never mind. We have. Well, you gotta be so rude.
I didn't say shit.
No, I'm sorry to that guy. We got one fun topic.
Ooh,
fun topic.
Related.
My nipples are hard just hearing it.
Related to Spider-Man.
Well, let's start with that.
Yeah, it's called Tom Hardy's retirement plan.
yeah.
He's on that Venom insurance.
Venom.
Yeah, let's start with that.
All right, so we're going to start off with the fun topic. All right.
Yeah.
What in... The fuck.
Sorry, that one kind of squeezed out. Damn, over there puking a shit, you pregnant bitch?
Yeah, everybody's farting. Everybody's.
So I'm thinking when I watch a Roman Reigns promo. Too much missionary position.
I can say the same fuck? For Johnny Gargano.
Oh, shut up.
Never heard of her. Oh, and then someone leaves.
Oh, yeah.
Come back in, you fuck!
Yeah, bear with me, guys, as I... As it's going slow as hell. Well, before I get it, okay, never mind. I got it. And we got five people.
Damn, everybody leaving for Christmas vacation early or something? Hoping you get your Christmas bonus? Well, you know what? You don't get shit! The asylum checks are for the asylum merch!
Okay, let's see here.
Right, that's like somebody's going through the garbage or something.
All right, so here we go.
Hey, the Tati champions are
back. Damn right, NNN is reunited.
Yes.
All right, so we're about to screen share here.
Oh, God, I hope it's porn.
Nope.
Oh, God, yeah. Oh, oh, fuck this, I'm leaving.
We got Stone Cold John Cena though.
Ah, Stone Bold. Damn it.
I don't want to talk about John Cena. What the fuck?
I do. Yay.
Who the fuck does?
I do.
No one cares what you watch.
Wow.
Oh, that's a spicy meatball.
All right, guys. So here's the first fun topic for tonight. The only fun topic for tonight.
Only one.
So. All right.
What?
So rank these six Spider-Man movies.
I got this one, you dumb son of a bitch. Spider-Man 2 and Fantastic Four. What?
What?
Yeah, what is right?
I'm sorry, I'm drunk on too many martinis. What?
So I was just like put in order, like what's number one or something?
Yeah, in order. Yeah, rank.
Okay.
Yeah. So
to all you juggalos and juggalettes out there, hell yeah! Woo woo! All
right. Yeah. Am I first?
No. Well, actually, yeah, you are.
Okay. Figures.
All right. Okay, I see it. Number one, Spider-Man 2. Number two, No Way Home. Number three, Spider-Man 1, 2002. Number four, Spider-Man 3. Number five, Homecoming. And number six, Far From Home.
Good eye.
Okay.
Oh, no Andrew movies, I just realized. Huh.
Oh, I just noticed. Good job.
Yeah, there's no Andrew movies.
Yeah, there's no amazing Spider-Man in there. I'm surprised.
No, I'm taking a guess. Andrew's your favorite Spider-Man.
Andrew's the jobber Spider-Man.
Wow. I do like Andrew. He was one of my favorites.
I'm just kidding.
Oh, no, I thought that was your number one favorite. It's like, is that your fit? Because, well, technically, if you're the age of 20 years old, you pretty much grew up with Andrew and Tom. But more Andrew. Yeah. That was
Yeah.
I think this was only for just Spider-Man and not for the amazing Spider-Man, I guess.
What's the fucking difference?
Exactly.
I mean, plus they both had well, for one, Amazing Spider-Man only had two movies.
Yeah.
That's the only part that sucks though, you know?
Yeah. But hey, hopefully he gets to hopefully it happens, you know, Spider-Man 3, Amazing Spider-Man 3, hopefully it happens.
Ah, fuck you.
What the fuck?
Yeah, RoboCop. I remember that.
RoboCock.
Nick Carter, you're up.
Spider-Man 1.
Okay.
Spider-Man 3.
Oh.
Spider-Man 2. The Amazing Spider-Man.
No, so we got 1, 2, 3, Homecoming, Far From Home, and The Way Home.
Homecoming. And Home Alone.
Home Alone? What?
Home Alone?
You mean Far From Home?
Far From Home, yeah.
You haven't seen No Way Home yet, Nick Carter?
Yeah.
You've seen it already? Or... What?
Do what?
What the hell?
The fuck are you doing? Pick your fucking Spider-Man movies.
So you haven't seen No Way Home yet? You haven't seen it yet?
I've seen Spider-Man 1 and Spider-Man 2 and Spider-Man 3, but I haven't seen Spider-Man Far From Home. And
have you ever seen the Amazing Spider-Man movies?
I've seen the one.
Oh shit, you gotta see part 2 and all that. You gotta catch it up to do.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. We'll just the next one then. Okay, Rem, you're up.
Oh, fuck. Spider-Man the Animated Series, Fantastic Four 2, Rise of Silver Surfer. The Punisher. X-Men Last Stand. Oh man. Spider-Man 1, 2, 3, Homecoming, Far From Home, and No Way Home. Because on my little phone, you really can't see shit.
Yeah.
Nice glasses, by the way.
I can't see it. Put them on fucking full screen.
Yeah, I can't see it.
Those are the natural born, killers fucking glasses.
He's the natural born Terminator.
I know exactly where those glasses came from. I know exactly what movie those came from. You gotta be an antique like me to know what that is. Robert got that fucking... Hey, Robert, you should grow the mustache out and curl it. You could get that Eggman look going on.
Dr. Eggman.
He looks like he just came out of a P. Diddy video from 96.
Junior Mafia.
All right.
Yeah, take that.
All right, Robert, you're next.
Number one for me will be Spider-Man 2. Number two will be for me Spider-Man. Number three will be for me Spider-Man 3. And I got into the garbages of Tom Holland Spider-Man.
Yeah!
Number four will be Homecoming. Number five will be No Way Home. And number six is Far From Home, because that was my least favorite. Because more stupidity of Tom Holland. I mean, there was a lot of stupidity of No Way Home 2, but we'll get to that. But
I got confused. I thought the last one was the Green Lantern, but oops, wrong one.
Green Lantern.
Yeah, Far From Home was pretty stupid.
But that's why I called it Far From Good.
Yeah, but hey, No Way Home, they redeemed themselves.
In my opinion. Yeah, they did.
Now, okay, anybody, people have read the Spider-Man comics. If you read deep into those things. Okay, the way they did Mysterio's character, is that how he was in the comics, or did they fuck him up?
I mean, it's pretty, like, this. Besides the whole drones thing, that was never really a thing, but the whole, like, you know, anything else, that's, yeah, the whole illusions thing, yeah, that's definitely Mysterio. Like, he's a fake.
They got the suit right.
He pretends to be a hero.
Booyaka, 6-1 Spidey.
Yeah, he has to be a hero. And we know he isn't.
Yeah. So they got that right.
And they did this too, with Mysterio of the Animated Spider-Man series, from the 90s.
Oh yeah, I remember that.
Apparently.
You know who I really want to see, like, be in the movie? I want to see Scorpion.
Hell yeah, I'd love to see that.
I want to see Scorpion and I want to see Chameleon. Y'all remember Chameleon?
What if they fuck it up and they put Scorpion in there, but it's actually the Mortal Kombat Scorpion? we went to the wrong universe. Shit. Get over here, Spidey!
No.
Fuck,
you know, what about Kraven the Hunter? Do you guys know who that is in the Spider-Man comic?
Of course, yeah. Of course.
Yeah,
I know Kraven the Hunter.
Imagine him in a movie.
Yeah. I think he might get his own movie. Kraven?
Okay. Who's going to get their own fucking movie?
Kraven the Hunter.
I don't know who that is.
You don't know Kraven the Hunter from Spider-Man?
He's a smart.
Okay. Oh, the Hunter. Yeah, well, he probably is. Yeah, that's the motherfucker that they wanted Keanu Reeves to play. I was like, nah, man, that ain't him. Nah, man, you gotta get a more rougher, tougher kind of guy with that shit. No offense, Keanu. Keanu Reeves is
John Wick. I don't see him.
By the way, I didn't even know this, but the new Matrix is already out. I didn't even fucking know that.
Oh, you guys seen the Matrix
already in theaters?
Yeah, apparently it is. I'm like, what?
I guess because of Spider-Man, we forgot about that.
Have you guys seen the Matrix game?
I heard about that. They're making.
I heard there's a game coming out too. I'm like, what the fuck?
I think
there's a game before the Matrix.
There was. It came out for like PlayStation 2, I do believe.
Oh, okay. All right. Cool. What the fuck?
I'm sorry, I fucking spaced out. Shit. Fuck. I don't know what happened. Shit, I fucking blacked out. What happened?
Alright, well, with that being said, Fapnik, go ahead and pick it.
Yeah, you're turning.
Okay.
Fuck, it's so damn funny!
Okay then.
It's a good song though.
Spider-Man 2. Spider-Man. Spider-Man Homecoming. Spider-Man No Way Home. Spider-Man 3. And then Spider-Man Far From Home.
Okay.
Good eye.
All right, so Stone Cold Cena, pick your figures 6.
All right, so number 1 would be 2015 Fantastic Four. Number 2 would be X-Men Last Best Standing.
See, that's spirit.
Number 3 would be Green Lantern. Number 4 would be Batman Forever. Number 5 would be Batman and Robin.
Actually, like Batman Forever.
And
Batman Forever.
I'm just kidding. All right. Okay, I'll get serious. Number 1 for me would be Spider-Man 2.
What the fuck?
Good to me.
What the hell?
Wow, I was about to jam, man.
Why is everybody saying Bill and Chuck's theme song? We're talking about Spider-Man movies.
Oh my god.
Number 2 would be Spider-Man. Number 3 would be Spider-Man 3. Let's see. I have not seen No Way Home, so I'm just not even gonna acknowledge that at the moment, but
that's cool.
But I would say number 4 would be Homecoming and number 5 would be Far From Home.
Ah.
And if you see No Way Home, then you put that above that. You know,
my favorite out of all of them, though, right there in that little list, since they don't have the Amazing Spider-Man, Spider-Man 2. Like, hands down.
Spider-Man 2 is definitely the best one.
All right, so for me, I'm going Spider-Man 2 at number 1, Spider-Man 1 at number 2, No Way Home at number 3, Spider-Man 3 at number 4, Far From Home at number 5, and Homecoming at number 6.
Well, that's surprising. You didn't like Homecoming at all?
No. No.
Oh, wow. Yeah, that movie sucked dick.
No.
Come on. You have to always say, help.
Help me. Oh, fuck. Okay. Oh, Tony Stark, come help me. Oh, God, yeah. Oh, my God, Andrew Garfield, somebody. Fuck.
Honestly, I don't really... I don't know. I kind of feel different about the scene nowadays, you know.
Help me, Sark. John Cena sucks. Help me.
Oh, God. Help me, Charlotte.
You want me to help with John Cena sucking, so.
Gotta help me with this shit. Really good idea.
Oh my god.
I always gotta tell John Cena.
Oh god. Don't get angry.
Jalen in the background.
The reaction when I saw Homecoming.
Okay, that scene right there, right? That's one. Two, the way Iron Man made him like such a bitch.
Yes.
Training wheels.
Yeah, the adults are talking. Motherfucker, yeah, just like who DIY you call a kid?
Training wheels for Johnny Gargano.
Oh,
if I was Spider-Man, I'd have pimped his ass right there. I'd be like, motherfucker, are you calling a kid? Telling me about the training wheels and shit, motherfucker. I got a dick. I got hair in my balls.
And I'd be like, man, no one knew who you are until you had your movie. Shut up.
Because again, and I brought this up before. Before he met Iron Man and the rest of them, he was just Spider-Man. No problems. All of a sudden, he meets Tony Stark. All of a sudden, he's an idiot.
Yeah, it's just it took away the element of Spider-Man every damn thing. It made it look like he couldn't do anything without, you know, Daddy Stark. You know, it fucking sucked.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But
Daddy Stark got a one-man allowance. He didn't exist.
Yeah. But like I said, it's all over now. Peter is all grown up. Now he's going to college, and hey, he's all by himself because he ain't got no Avengers. So
I'm only hoping one thing for Peter. Please tell me you hit that pussy before she got her memory erased.
He probably did.
Maybe he did.
He found a way.
Found a way.
To me, I don't know. I don't think he did.
What the fuck kind of song is that?
Oh, come on.
I don't think he did.
Well, you gotta. Well, at least
they kissed. I mean, they kissed. You know, that should be good enough, I guess. You know,
yeah,
he found never... a way, like the way when the Rock beat John Cena.
Huh? What?
the what?
I was about to say, hey, you never know. You might find Gwen Stacy in the future. You never know.
Maybe.
You might get Gwen Stacy. Let's just hope, you know, break her neck like Andrew did.
Stacy Keebler?
I guess that's all that should end.
Let's have Charlotte there.
Well, yeah, you know, Gwen didn't have any fucking Allstate insurance, so, you know, yeah, shit happens.
Oh.
Wait. But yeah, Christian,
somebody said if they do have Amazing Spider-Man 3, they should bring back Gwen as Gwen Spidey. Oh, like, how the fuck would that happen?
How would that happen?
Yeah. That would have to cross the universe and maybe if you fuck something up with the time universe and because of that cross lane, can you imagine like they said, well, she's alive because something happened during that time when you guys fucked up the Ultraverse.
Spider-Man to Spider-Verse, live action.
Pretty much. I mean,
yeah.
I mean, the whole, multiverse is a thing, so I wouldn't be surprised if they actually did do that. Probably. And I remember when they were gonna make a Spider-Man, Amazing Spider-Man 3, they did talk about like bringing back some dead characters. That's what I heard. So
yeah, the animation. We can bring back Bonesaw. All we gotta do is get Seth Rollins on some major steroids and tan him up.
Oh, come on, not Seth Rollins.
Bonesaw's ready.
Oh God, no.
Oh God, I've got
Birdsaw. Saw it down, burn it down.
Drip on is ready.
But to let Christian know. But to let Christian know about Tom Holland when he first appeared on Captain America, with chance of him being just Spider Man before he met Iron Man. I thought he was in it before, so
maybe.
I thought he was in it before he met Iron Man.
He did have a bad costume, but then again, I ain't gonna blame for the shitty costume and the sweatpants, because he's a kid, he didn't know what to do to make a costume. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And you can't really ask your Aunt May to make you shit when she's not supposed to know who the fuck you are.
Yeah, exactly.
Yep.
But there you go.
That's whatever.
Well, speaking of Spider-Man, can we talk about Amazing Spider-Man 3?
Christian?
Yeah, I had to get a drink.
Okay, yeah, he got
you drink 14 beers.
Better get 14. That's what makes you a man.
Save your tears for another day.
Save your beers for another day.
So, what were you asking me?
Amazing Spider-Man 3.
Oh, yeah, there's rumors. Of it actually happening.
Do it. Please do it.
Question. Who was the original director of Amazing Spider-Man?
Mark Webb.
And who's now has the rights for to do Spider-Man now for Disney?
It was really Sony, because Sony owns like all the Spider-Man characters. So
technically, Marvel could make an Amazing Spider-Man.
No. Oh my God!
What the fuck?
Shut up!
Oh. Come on, help him!
That's the one. Fuck! I'm trying to watch Fantastic Four.
That's the one. But he's going out for help.
It's the Marvel.
They're experiencing the event of watching John Cena, man.
Oh, come on.
Nah, man, that's the fucking sound you make when you had to stick with those Joey Ryan matches back then.
Oh, yeah, I couldn't imagine that. Hello?
Well, yeah,
that's me.
Oh my god, no dick flips, no!
That's me after the Raids with the match.
That's what happened when Johnny Gargano won the NXT Championship.
Yeah. Oh God!
Anyway,
I hope there is Amazing Spider-Man 3, because there's some unfinished business there with all the villains that we haven't got a chance to get through.
Yeah, and originally in Amazing Spider-Man 3, there was gonna be a Sinister Six. There was.
Yeah, oh wow.
They were gonna have because like I remember like in the ending like they showed like some background like. They showed like Dr. Octopus mechanical arms. They showed Vulture's wings. And then they had Rhino. I guess they were going to
bring should actually Green have Lantern. The real Rhino show up and talk about goring people.
Gore. I think they were going to have Kraven the Hunter in the movie. And
I also see Kraven.
What's wrong with Kraven?
Instead of Kraven, we replace him with Maven.
What about me? What about Kraven?
What about me? What about Kraven? Well, we don't care enough to put you in the movie. I'm sorry. Low budget.
And I think they were going to put Chameleon in there. I could be wrong. But they were going to have a Sinister Six in Amazing Spider-Man 3. But
Well, I mean, we were going to have more villains, but we had to do budget cuts.
Oh, no. But,
Sony has officially released Dr. Octopus.
Oh, dude, if they do, I hope Doc Ock is all elite. I really do.
or all DC.
I do wonder with this multiverse now. I wonder like what Spider-Man would be with Tom Hardy's Venom though. Like, or he's in his own like separate universe though.
Andrew Garfield, like, really? Andrew Garfield.
Yeah. Do you think he'd be in the same? Him and Andrew Garfield be the same universe with each other? Do you think that?
I think he could. Yeah, I mean
he could be. You never know.
I mean, Tobey Maguire already faced. He already faced Venom.
That is true. So that could be a setup. Tom Hardy's Venom versus
Andrew. Here's a good one. Here would be a good one. Have Eric show up as Venom, and then have the new Tom Hardy Venom beat the shit out of that one. How about that?
But yeah. And besides, Andrew said he wants to fight an alien. Like in the room, he's like, "I want to fight an alien."
He
might get that wish. You know, he can face Venom, so that'd be cool. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and like you said, like the multiverse, like with the whole multiverse thing that's happening with Marvel, I could see probably maybe they could have a Gwen Stacy come back, but as you know, Spider Gwen. The thing is, would they get Emma Stone to come back? That's the question.
I don't know. Is she up for it?
Yeah, no, that'd be cool. Get
Charlotte to play Spider Gwen.
I'm not watching that movie. Anyway, I don't want to see Gwen Stacy doing woo, like no.
Hey, we play with Tom Hardy's Spider-Man. At least you could do is pull off clear face.
They could even get fucking Rhino that damn right, man. I just didn't care about a fucking whacked out heroin act looking motherfucker in a big RoboCop Rhino suit. Fucking sure, Robo Rhino sure, chip. Oh, sure. Spider-Man, I found you. Like what?
Why is Rhino sound like Arnold?
it's almost what he sounded like when he talked. He almost tried to do an Arnold. The guy was trying to do like a Russian accent. It wasn't really that good.
Yeah, Paul Giamatti. Yeah,
Paul Giamatti. He's got movies that are good, but then he's got some that's like a villain in a comic movie. You are not that.
He's a great actor.
If you want to, they should have done it like Deadpool, where they would actually look like Juggernaut, but actually get a big CGI muscle dude in a Rhino suit.
Yeah.
He's a grappler too,
though,
but I didn't see him as
Spider-Man.
Yeah, he sucked.
Yeah. And I feel like with Andrew Garfield's universe, like, I feel like it's more to be a little more realistic. That's what I've really noticed is that they try to be a little more realistic. That's why the Ron looked like that. That's why Green Goblin, you know, looked more like a crack addict instead of actual, like, Green Goblin.
Dude, what the fuck did they do with that other Green Goblin? What the fuck was that?
That
motherfucker looked like he was on heroin and all the like a motherfucker boy. Just fucking
He literally was on heroin and robbed a military base or something.
Dude, he looked like that bully kid that was in the movie The Christmas Story, like all grown up, fucked up on heroin.
Oh no.
Like, seriously, dude, bad teeth and all, man. Yeah, I'm the Green Lantern. Yeah. Like, what the fuck is that? Like, holy shit.
Me.
No, you betrayed yourself, homeboy. When's the last time you had a shower? Shit. man.
Like I said, I wouldn't mind seeing, I would definitely not mind seeing Ace Spider-Man 3, especially seeing Andrew's performance in No Way Home. Hey, why not?
They actually lied to people.
That wasn't Green Goblin. That was actually one of the long lost sons of Macaulay Culkin.
What were you saying, Robert?
But yeah, I think because after they see his performance from No Way Home, I think they are considering him, to have some offense business with Spider-Man 3. So
yeah,
if he's up for it, I'm pretty sure he is, which is why he came back. So.
Yeah, I mean, and the movie did really great. You know, it made a whole lot of money and people were loving it. So why not?
Yeah.
Why not do it? I wouldn't mind, man. You know, I'd definitely love to see that.
All right. So.
Yeah, me too.
What? I guess we could
What the fuck? I'm trying to see your picture in the bottom. What the hell is that? Oh, is that all bald John's chemo Cena?
That looks so weird, bro. But what you said, Christian?
What the fuck? Dude, that motherfucker looks like Cena just graduated Kurt Angle College. What the fuck?
Kurt Angle College. You guys, you know, you give your brief thoughts on, you know, for those of you who watched it, your brief thoughts on No Way Home. What'd you think about it?
It was amazing. I think
it's pretty funny that Nick's picture is close to Spider-Man's crotch.
I got a lot to say about it.
It was amazing. I loved it.
Besides, it was good.
It was like The Notebook. It just took my breath away. You had some familiar faces show up. It had a good story. I gotta say, out of the three movies that Tom has done, well, the Spider-Man movies he's done, I like this one the most.
Yeah, and they, this is how you do fan service. They did it so well, bro. Like, this is fan service, like, well done. Like, they actually knew the material. They actually respect the material, and they actually remembered who these characters are. Because they could have easily just made them. Oh, look at that! They have Green Goblin back. Oh, that's cool. You know, but no, they actually did more with these characters. You know, the whole thing about this movie was, you know, second chances. And
well, Dafoe didn't miss a fucking step. Not a fucking step.
Nope, he did not. Dude, he was him and Andrew was the highlight of the movie for me.
Yeah, Peter, you're pissing me off.
Dude, that fight scene, bro, with Tom and Goblin, phenomenal, bro.
Peter, how would you like me to get my glider into your nuts?
Oh, and when he killed Aunt May and tried to bomb her, bro, and like when. Dude.
Yeah, but over there spoiling that shit for people that haven't even seen it yet. They're going to be like, man, fuck that guy with the Spider-Man picture. He's spoiling it for me.
Well,
well, I mean,
there was someone else that did.
Oh, don't tell me about the scene, Smark. Damn it.
But all I'm going to say is, like, if you're a huge Spider-Man fan like I am, bro, this is definitely the movie for you. You haven't watched it. Mm-hmm. This is.
Yeah.
It respects all three generations of Spider-Man, Toby, Andrew, and Tom. Like,
as you can see, Spider-Man. He has an amazing display picture of Spider-Man from Amazing Spider-Man. The artist formerly known as Andrew.
Yep.
Yeah. And I'm going to say is Andrew was, he was the MVP of the movie. He was. Toby, like, he had his time to shine as well. And Tom, I think, Tom really got me, like, you know what? This movie, he really convinced me. He like, okay, you know what? Yeah, he got it.
I'll say that. The new movie, how Tom got his group back.
Well, at the end, he did. He finally figured out, you know, how to be Spider-Man now.
Yeah. Once he finally,
I made my own suit and didn't ask my sugar daddy, Mr. Stark, to make it.
Well, he's dead, so he can't really do that.
Yeah, Urban dead.
Like once he like lost a loved one, like he wanted to like legit kill, you know? He wanted to tear it, like bro, like he was pissed, like, you know. And hey, he was giving it to, you know, Goblin, bro. He was like giving him them hands, like for real.
Toby had to step in it, boy, and make sure he wouldn't kill him.
Yeah, like when he picked
up. No joke. Before he injected him with that serum in the neck, I thought he stabbed him, killed him.
That's what I thought too. Until I said, "Oh, he got the serum." I was like, "Whoa, Peter is like, oh no, that's the serum." Never.
Yeah, Andrew was like, "Man, fuck this shit, kill this motherfucker." East Side, Wu-Tang.
Great power must also. And great responsibility.
Great power comes great ass whippings.
Yes.
Now I don't read much comics with Spider-Man. Is that what they always say in the comics?
Yeah, it's a saying in all the movies.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, Bonesaw said it in the first one. I mean, Ben.
Both of them saw it.
With great power comes great responsibility. You got that, Peter?
I don't know why you're saying it, but Uncle Ben was here.
Right? But go ahead, Robert.
All right. Yeah, I thought the movie was good. You know, better than obviously way better than Far From Home.
Oh yeah.
Fuck Far From Good.
And Homecoming. Yeah.
And Homecoming too, combined.
I can forgive
Homecoming. Fuck Homecoming too.
I can forgive it a little bit, Homecoming, but Far From Home nah.
Mm-mm. I didn't give a fuck about No Coming and fucking Far From Good.
I couldn't forget the whole thing where when I first saw Homecoming. Spider-Man saw some guy on the bike, whatever, and took the bike away from him and was like, hey, this guy stole some Spider-Man. Like, what are you talking about? do you remember that part?
Mm-hmm. I wanna ride my Spidey soul. I wanna ride my Spike.
I don't remember much of it because I only watched it one time and I just didn't care for it.
That's the best thing to do, Robert, is not remember it.
I guess. But I constantly kept on seeing Far From Home because I had nephews and nieces to watch it with and like, oh damn it, gotta watch this movie because
Yeah, Robert's thinking crap.
Oh man, and I gotta keep hearing Led Zeppelin. No, it's AC/DC, moron.
How the fuck do you get that? How the fuck do you get that switched up? Led Zeppelin to AC/DC.
God, yeah, it pissed me off.
One sounds like they've been smoking cigarettes their whole life, and the other one sounds a little screechy. Difference.
But back to No Way Home. Yeah, I enjoyed it. It was great to see James Jameson back. Even though he's bald now.
They
should have had him wear a. They should have gave him a toupee like they did the other ones.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Put the toupee back on.
Spider-Man, I gotta wear a toupee again. You stress me out.
Spider-Man is it's a
real. Dude, amazing. Don't make me call Bald Saul.
But I love the fight scene that Spider-Man had with Doctor Strange. Even with the fight scene with Doc Ock.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Even though it's not with Tobey Maguire, but still with Tom Holland, going up against Dr. Octopus was great. And I love seeing Dr. Octopus. He never a step either.
No.
Yeah. It was so cool seeing the Iron Spider versus the mechanical arms. That was so cool.
Yeah, I thought that was cool.
Hey, Doc Ock was looking pretty fresh, but he got some of that nanotech on his arms, that looked pretty sick.
Oh yeah. I love how his arms was controlling him now because he ripped off parts of
the Iron Squid.
I thought
that was cool.
Yeah, because the point he was taking,
call me the Iron Puss.
Because Doc Ock said he had Spider-Man in the throat because he remembered Spider-Man 2, he was choking Peter.
Yeah.
It'd be funny if when he took his mask off, he's like, "You're not Peter, son. What grade are you in?"
He's like, "You're not Peter Parker."
Peter Parker's actually a man. How old are you? 10? This is not. It'd be funny if you said, "This is far from good."
and then Green Goblin showed up.
Oh yeah,
and that was great. So basically, they catch some bad guys into to this thing. They got the loser first, I think it was, and then there.
Yeah, man, that should have been a meme when they all showed up at one time. But when all your baby mamas show up to the same court.
The loser was first to be in the prison, and then he put Doc Ock in there.
Sandman was in there.
Well, before Sandman actually
not the
was
one with the cane, though.
Well, yeah, Sandman was. Samuel was actually trying to help Spider-Man because remember they were on good terms in Spider-Man 3. So that was actually cool to see. It's like, wow, they remembered.
Electro got caught too.
Remember they were talking to his buddy and shit. He's like, "What happened to your buddy and shit?" My buddy pretty much tried to kill me. And he died in my arms.
Oh yeah.
Wow. Well, here. Well.
Well, yeah, we'll get to that part too.
Okay, never mind.
When they try to find the cure and all that, right? And Dr. Octopus was not into it. because he's thinking Tom Holland was, you know, is an idiot. He's like, oh, he's gonna kill us all. And I was like, yep, he is. I was right there with Dr. Octavius when he said he's gonna kill us.
yeah, even
Doctor. Because they try to find an antidote to on the cure of their, you know, take away the superpowers of the story.
Yeah, even Doc Ock has seen the previous movies.
Yes.
Yeah.
And also we talked about this before, but I got to talk about this again. I hate that, you know, they make fun of his name, Otto Octavius. Like,
yeah. What's your real name again, Doctor Otto? Otto Service? What?
Now Peter Parker from McGuire would never have done that. But Tom Holland, of course he would. Of course he would.
Yeah, he's
an idiot.
That's just part of the MCU humor, and that's what they do.
I think they should have had Doc Ock have a comeback with that one.
Exactly.
You know, because even though this is not really like a big, you know, insult to, you know, Toby, you know, brilliant but lazy, you know, type of, you know.
Yeah, well, and that's nothing. I wish he would have said that, by the way. Brilliant but lazy. Not to Tom, obviously, but.
Yeah, Toby.
But to Toby.
I mean, it would have been cool if he asked, like, you know, are you still brilliant but lazy?
Yeah, something like that.
But hey, you know, it was still cool to see.
And then Norman Osborn getting caught too. And then, you know, that's when the fight scene happened between Doctor Strange and Spider-Man, and Spider-Man got the better of Doctor Strange, which, you know, is unheard of.
Yeah.
When he did the shit to Strange, I was thinking, Spider-Man couldn't do that to Strange. I'm sorry, that was a little
not this Spider-Man. No,
like, come on now. Like, Doctor Strange got outdid him. Maybe so, like, they kind of like, well, damn, Doctor Strange, you didn't have much mojo in this one, did you?
No, I guess not.
But I almost forgot, like, freaking when Norman Osborn was in the cage, he literally said, you know, I'm something of a scientist myself. It was like, oh,
yes,
my God,
he said it. He did.
Yeah, so a scientist himself. Oh, really?
And right there, he got Tom Holland on Hook, Line, Sinker. Yeah. Once they released and all that, and, you know, and Dr. Octopus was back to normal. He throws up the camera once again because the whole ship thing. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, Electro, he was going to turn back to normal too, but then also we see Norman Osborn the Green Goblin to take control of him. And from there, all hell broke loose.
We gotta talk about the spider sense. Cause like,
yeah.
Dude, that was so intense. Like when he was sensing something, when he's like, he couldn't really figure out what it was.
Yeah.
It's like, why? And Electro's like, why are you looking at me like that? It's like, he's just sensing like, what's going on? And then he whips, like, he shoots a web at Norman. He's like, oh man, the goblin's back.
Yep.
Oh shit, some green lunatic is back. Fuck.
And he's pretty much saying, you know, these are not curses, these are gifts.
Somebody's gonna look at that and be like, what the fuck happened to the Ninja Turtle?
So yeah,
I would have been laughing my ass off if people would have been expecting his Green Goblin and the shitty one from Amazing Spider-Man 2 showed up.
Oh no.
Here I am. Oh, we're just kidding. Here comes Norman.
I'm glad that he did. I'm actually glad he didn't show up.
Oh, thank fucking Jesus, bald titty fucking Christ he didn't, because I would have hated that.
But Electro decided to take it off, and Sandman side with them, and he did, unfortunately.
It's so funny because, like, Sandman, all he wanted to do was go home and see his daughter.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was the only thing that sucked. They changed a little bit of that. I was like, well, why are you being a bad guy?
Yeah, and then Lizard also he escapes from the rubber on the van they put him in because, you know, he's unstable.
Yeah. Inside a giant lizard in the apartment.
Yeah. And then when the Green Goblin was escaping after what he did to John May, you see him in a purple hoodie. I said to myself, yes, I love it. I love it. I that's old school. Yes, that's old school Green Goblin.
Yeah, that's old school, bro. Like the purple hoodie, bro. It's like, yes. Yeah. I mean, don't get me wrong. I love the mask, you know, but
I mean, it's just so classic. Mask is cool. Yeah, mask is cool.
But just seeing the classic hood, it's like, oh man, this is like old school Goblin right here.
Yes, I love it.
Also, I like the part where like Electro, you know, uses electricity to throw Doc Ock out the window. I thought that was pretty cool.
Oh yeah.
It's like I like the old you better.
I like the old you better, bitch.
And I love the fact like with Electro, like when he has the electricity, like it creates like the star mask, you know?
Yes.
Yeah, they made it the original Electro. That was pretty cool.
That was
the yellow and like it was so. I was like, oh, I love that.
Awesome, man.
Yes.
You see, it's those type of nostalgias, you know, is why I was enjoying this movie.
yeah.
And let's see what else. When I May Die, and then you see Tom Holland, yo, feeling sad. I'm sorry, I couldn't feel any emotions because of one thing, it was his fault. Because
it was his
fault. He had opportunity to send those bad guys away, you know, to their own universe.
Yeah,
and it was his fault. He took the blame. He took the blame. He admitted it was his fault because he's an idiot.
I mean, you could say the same thing for like, you could kind of say the same thing about the other Peters, like when their loved ones
died. This has nothing to do with this movie, but let's never forget the famous scene in Spider-Man 1 with Kirsten Dunst's nipples showing through her dress when it was raining.
Oh, that was great.
Oh, yes. That was just wonderful. Yes. What a great scene.
I mean, you gotta remember, like, Toby and Andrew, they believed it was their fault that their loved ones died. You know, it's pretty much the same thing with Tom. Them too.
Apparently, Toby and his Mary Jane are going through a rocky time right now, but that happens. You fight, it happens.
No, I think he said that they're trying to make it work.
It's complicated.
Yeah, but they're trying to make it work. But so it was cool to, you know, okay, they're still kind of together. They're just trying to make it work.
But here's the thing. I did feel, you know, a little sad in me that Aunt May died the way she died too.
Yeah.
But I'm sorry, but when Tom Holland's crying, I see myself, I can't, because I don't see Tom Holland as Peter Parker or Spider-Man. I still don't. Even at the end, he finally started to prove himself that he is. After all the Homecoming and the Far From Home, and then you could say what it seems to Avengers and Captain America, I still don't see him as Spider-Man.
For me personally, like when that happened and like when that happened, that's when he really started becoming Spider-Man to me.
If Toby would have showed up in the black suit and started dancing, that would have made the movie 10 out of 10.
honestly, that scene right there when Aunt May got killed and when she said, "With great power comes great responsibility," I was like, okay, this is Spider-Man right now. This is for real Spider-Man.
Exactly.
And this is really gonna change him up.
I think they turned up a notch, but I at the same time wasn't feeling that much. But I thought Aunt May got hit with the glider. She survived it, and then also she started going down, and then like, oh man, she's dead.
Yeah. It's like, because I knew someone was gonna die, and I had a feeling Aunt May would, but man, it was like it was really sadder than I thought it was gonna be. Like, jeez.
Never thought that she was going to die. Didn't think she was going to die.
Yeah, because it was going around that people thought that that Happy was going to be the one that was going to die.
Yeah, but when you think about it, that wasn't really...
But, oh, come on.
He was a smart.
When you really think about it, would that really, like,
impact Happy was a fat fuck.
It wouldn't really impact Peter all that much. It's like, he wouldn't really do nothing. I mean, he'll feel bad, but like, I don't think that really like hurt him to the point where, like, you know, I may get killed. So
I like Happy though. I like him though.
Yeah, I like him. I'm just saying, like, if he did get killed, it wouldn't really do much, really.
I don't know. Yeah.
Yeah, it wouldn't be as emotional as it was.
Yeah.
And believe me, I want to feel emotional about Aunt May dying too. Because she, you know, she really did play out, you know, Aunt May very well.
Yeah,
and then we get to, you know, Andrew, you know, at, you know, Miss Spider-Man comes in.
Yeah,
people pop. then Toby came in, Toby McGuire, yo, and he came in. I was like, holy shit!
Oh my god,
Toby McGuire!
I was screaming, bro, like when I saw.
I know when Toby showed up, everybody was like, "All right, now get the damn black suit." Yeah, I start dancing, damn it. You should. You know what? He should have came through the portal and just told him, "Oh, you're gonna cry."
I lost my mind when I saw Toby come out. Like, oh my god!
Yeah, now we're getting somewhere.
Looking like a bunch of grown men that were like schoolgirls. Oh my god, Tom is so cute. I know.
Like original personalities in the movie, like you know, like Tobey Maguire. You know, he's a nice guy. You know, really polite. You know. I mean, like when he saw the old lady, he's like, "Oh, hello!" He's like, you know, he's just like, he's so cool, and like, you know, Andrew's like, you know,
that's because he was thinking, "Damn, what a hot piece of ass!" Hello.
It was just so refreshing, and it was so cool to see them. Like when Toby and Andrew saw each other, I was like, "What the hell?" And then the first thing they think about is to web each other. And it's like, "Oh man, that was so awesome!"
I know when they fucking see each other, they fucking turn into the Yum Bucks.
Oh,
man. Like, they both start doing flips and kicks. I'm like, oh, shit.
Oh, no.
Oh, here come the young Spideys.
And Tom Holland is a Marco stunt.
Oh, no. Now watch the young Bucks come out dressed as Spider-Man. Oh, shit. Here come the young webs.
Oh, no. The young webs.
The young webs. That's a good one. That's a good one.
Super web party.
Yeah, but, that's right.
But then they went to find Peter, you know, Tom Holland, on the Empire State Building.
Yeah, that part was really emotional.
That one got me emotional. Not because of Tom Holland, but because of Tobey Maguire, and then a little bit pertains to Andrew Garfield. Because to me, I'm still in that mood that I'm sorry, but I cannot get into Tom Holland.
Me, that was really emotional, like, you know, seeing him all depressed and, like, when MJ and Ned came to hug him and, like, he was crying. Like, and then that's when, when Toby and Andrew came, like, you know, he said, like, no, I'm going to bring you back to your world. I'm going to bring the villains back to their worlds. Like, it's not my problem. I'm going to kill Goblin. Like, I'm over this. And, like, and Toby and Andrew, they were talking about, you know, their losses, you know, when Toby lost Uncle Ben, saying it was his fault.
I keep hearing that they actually want to make a Miles Morales Spider-Man movie.
Oh, yeah, we'll get to that part.
Well, they are making an animated movie.
No, I didn't want to make a live action.
Live action.
They need to do live action. Maybe Miles Morales can replace Peter Parker or Tom Holland. You never know.
Maybe,
but I gotta see how they do it. But when they were talking about their loss, you know, especially Andrew, man, Andrew, he was very emotional when he talked about that.
Yeah, especially with Booker Stacy.
Yeah, when he lost Gwen, it was like he can never forgive himself, and like he said, he got rageful, he got bitter. And he's like, I don't want you to be like me.
Well, yeah, I mean, that's why they say in every superhero movie and shit that you can't kill; it just makes you more angrier. It doesn't solve anything.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, like Toby said.
Well, except for some people that you meet on YouTube or see on TV that you just don't give a fuck about. Yeah, then that's the right time for that kind of shit.
Yeah.
Yeah. But,
you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
like, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, but like Toby. Yeah,
motherfucker.
Like, yeah, but Toby said, like, you know, I wanted to kill it dead. He's like, that'd make me feel any better.
No.
Yeah.
You said I wanted to kill her?
No. Like when Toby said he wanted his killer, like when he killed Uncle Ben, he said he wanted him dead.
Oh.
And like he said, that'd make it any better.
Well, of course, he hunted him down and, you know, I missed the part where that was my problem.
Nice.
Yeah.
You know, that would have been a cool line right there, David, if they like, why didn't you help Tom? I missed the part where that was my problem.
But yeah, and then like when Tom was about to say with great power, and Toby said with comes great responsibility, and, like Tom was like, "How do you know that?" He was like, "Uncle Ben said that before he died."
With great power comes shitty sequels. What?
What?
And like he said, like, and Toby said, "She didn't die for nothing, Peter." And that's what motivated Tom. That's what motivated him.
Yeah,
and they were teaming up together in the lab, which was it was a cool scene seeing them together in the lab. I love the part like when Ned gives Tom his web shooters. He's like, and Toby's like, "What's that?" He's like, "Oh, this is my web flow for my web shooters." It's like, why need that? And then like he just flips something. Like he just, you know, shoots a web. He's like, "That came out of you." Yeah.
Yeah.
You can't do that, huh? And like Andrew was like,
"Yeah, that came out of you. Yeah, you should see my dick cheese."
Oh. But like Andrew was like, it's like, how the hell does that even happen? He was like so shocked. Yeah, because Andrew and Tom, they have to use web shooters. Toby, nah, he's organic. You don't need to worry about that.
But I love it. I love that. You know, when Tom McGuire became that, you know. Yeah, when they did the Spider-Man movie back in 2002, and I saw that part where the web came out of it, like, I thought that was cool. Because originally it's the web shooter thing that
they used
in the comments.
Yeah. Honestly, I think it makes them feel more like a mutant, you know, like a legit spider, you know? Nothing gets web shooters, but I'm just saying. It makes them feel more like
that comes out of you and shit. It's like, yeah, Mary Jane likes that shit. She loves that fucking nut cheese.
And I think it was Tom Holland who mentioned, like, does any other size of the webs come out of you? Or just other parts of, like,
of course you
do. I'm like, what the fuck are you? What the fuck are you talking about?
Yeah, figures, Tom. You'd be asking about dick cheese.
I was like, whoa, Tom. Okay, whoa. He's like,
oh, does it come out of your other end? No, usually during a cavity search, it usually comes out.
It's like just a wrist.
Just a wrist.
Oh, there was actually this one part of, like when Ned was he said Peter, like all three was like, yeah. He's like, no, the other Peter. It was like which Peter? It's like
Yeah,
like, and I just realized like it's like that was like the Spider-Man meme where like both Spider-Man are pointing at each other. That was basically the meme.
They should have done that scene.
They should have pointed at each other.
Yeah, they did. They were pointing at each other. It's like, wait, which one are you talking about? I was like,
I must say, I'm not seeing the property portion. But basically, I'm talking about, you know, if they're in their suits, you know, together. You know.
Yeah, that would have been cool.
But
when they went to the.
Okay, before we get to the next one, now I got to talk about this. Tom McGuire mentioned, because, you know, someone, I think it was Ned who asked Toby, though.
Yeah, Ned.
Did you have a best friend?
Yeah, he did.
So he asked him to Toby, do you have a best friend? And like, yeah, he tried to kill me. And he died in my arms, not that. I can't remember how he said that. And I said, he didn't die in your arms because he tried to kill you. He was, what the fuck? Like,
yeah. That was not. Like, yeah, no, he was unconscious and he lost his memory. That's like.
Yeah.
While they were fighting.
Yeah, he was unconscious when he tried to kill you. I think they kind of messed up that.
Oh my god, that was ridiculous! Like, what the fuck, man? For those that watch, Spider-Man 3, that's not what happened. He didn't die in his arms because he tried to kill him.
No, he was unconscious.
Yeah, he was
died in his arms when he tried to save him.
Yeah, he was unconscious in his arms.
Yeah, he was unconscious like when he tried to kill him. But like he died when Harry tried to save him, because Venom tried to stab him with his glider, but then Harry sacrificed himself.
Yeah,
a little mess up there.
Couldn't believe that was even in the script.
Yeah, I'm surprised Toby didn't call them out. Like, wait a minute, that's not what happened though in the movie. Like, I'm surprised, but I mean. It's...
One more thing before, I think like when Tom came and like Ned was talking to him, it's like, I promise I will not try to kill you.
I was thinking to myself, I don't think he needs to worry about that.
Too late, Spark.
He's like, and like Tom's like, what the hell? Okay. But yeah, like we get to the next scene, the best scene of the movie. This was the best. This is the best final. This is the best final fight I've seen in MCU. But before they were even got to the fight, they were in the
Statue of Liberty.
Yeah. And then they were just talking, you know, they were just chilling. And, yeah, they were talking about how, like, you know, Tom acts like, what's the craziest villains you faced? And yeah. Toby, yeah, he's like, I fought an alien made of a black goo once. And he's like, oh, that's cool. I fought an alien, too.
You fought an alien turd.
He's like, I fought an alien, too, in space. He was purple. He's like, and Andrew's like, I want to fight him.
Not just Daniels, but other aliens he fought too in other games.
Yeah. And he's like,
the main alien is the purple guy that he said.
Yeah. He's like, I'm lame compared to y'all, man. I just fought a guy in a rhino suit. It's like Toby was like, nah, man, you're amazing, man. You are amazing.
I fought Rhino and you know, he gored me.
It's like it was both refreshing. It was both like oh, that's cool, and pretty much a reference because you know Andrew is the amazing Spider-Man. So like that was.
I'm waiting for other stuff to come. I'm still waiting for the She-Hulk series.
Oh yes, She-Hulk! I can't wait for that, man. That's gonna be awesome. I can't wait for She-Hulk, and I am looking forward to Moon Knight too. I want to see what that's all about. That was
Moon.
Cool.
Yeah,
Moon Knight.
Oh, the fuck that is.
Yeah, I want to check it out though. It looks kind of interesting.
Pretty cool. Very cool.
Yeah. Oh yeah. When Toby like well first Andrew asks like, hey, have you ever had a web block? He's like, because you know we actually create a web shooter. So like, well I did once. You know. I had a crisis. Spider-Man. You know.
Spider-Man.
Yeah, 2. Yeah, Spider-Man 2. You know that's when he was losing his webs because you know emotions. Mm-hmm. But yeah. Oh, and like when. Well, like he was trying to fix his back, it's like my back, you know.
Yes, yes. Reference from Spider-Man 2.
Yes, my back. And then like Andrew actually helps, like you know, cracks his back for him. He's like, oh, that feels better.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, if he fixes back problems.
That was amazing. No point.
Yeah. Yeah. But and I think that's when the villains came. Electro.
Yes. And they all start fighting.
Yeah, you know,
one by one, they all start getting to know because of the antidote, whatever, that, you know, to cure them.
Well, before that, they were kind of having some trouble. They're kind of having some trouble with the villains.
Yeah.
Because they're not, because except for Toby, they're not really used to, you know, teaming up. Well, Tom is, but Toby.
But Toby and Andrew never had that, you know. Never had teams.
Really. Yeah. But then, like, when Tom says, I don't mean to brag, but I was part of the Avengers. They're like, Toby? yo, Toby said, the Avengers? That's great. What is that?
Yeah, that was funny.
Dude, the theater, like, when they heard that, they were dying, bro. I was like, wait. Tom, I was like, wait, you don't have the Avengers? Like, Andrew's like, wait, is that a band? And you're in a band? Like, dude, that was the funniest part. Yeah, because yeah, Toby and Andrew, they don't have the Avengers in their universes. It's like
yeah.
So, yeah. So that's made it funny. But it's like, how's this helping? Yeah, but then they work together again, you know, try again and they succeed.
And it worked this time.
Yeah. And here's what I've noticed with Sam and the Lizard.
They should have all got together and just had a game bait on Gwen.
Oh, okay. Like, yeah, because, like, when Toby cured Sandman, they definitely, because, like, if you look back at it, they did reuse, like, the scene from Spider-Man 3. Like, yeah. That's exactly, like, what they reused, but, like, they edited it. To where yeah. You know he's turning, and the same thing for Lizard because it's exactly how it was in Amazing Spider-Man, mm-hmm. but like he's getting cured.
Yeah.
Now, I heard like the actors like they were able to do the voices for the characters. They did do the voices, but they couldn't do the live action.
Yeah, I heard about that.
Yeah, I think it's because of COVID because this was filmed during COVID, so
yeah.
I think that's why they weren't really available. I guess.
Right.
So that's why it's like that. That's why Sandman was all sandy because Thomas wasn't there. So, but hey, at least they got the voices. So that's all I cared about. I'm glad they had the voices.
The yeah.
Yeah. So, hey, at the end of the day, they got the voices back. It was cool. So I was cool with it. But yeah, they cured Lizard, they cured Sandman, and then with Doc Ock, it looks like Doc Ock was like, you know, I'm gonna team up with them, you know. Well, like, remember, yeah, he got cured because
he got me a little bit for that.
Yeah, he was like, wait, man, no. But then like he fooled him and like he cured Electro. And then
yes, man.
It'd be funny if they gave a cure to Electro and he turned white. Like, wait a minute, what?
But
something right here. No, they're like, they cure me, turns blue again. Like, what the fuck?
but Alfred playing Dr. Octopus, you know, and the way he did the turn, you know, like, yeah, he's still got it, man. He's a great actor.
But yeah,
he sure is. But I do love how Doc Ock in 2000, you know, something was a little chubbier. No shit, a little chubbier back then, and then comes back a little thinner. You know, I guess he lost weight while he was dead. You know, but, insane. You know, motherfucker was taking that DDP yoga.
I guess.
Yeah, but Andrew went to check on Electro. I was like, well, guess I'm going back to being a nobody. It's like, because remember the Amazing Spider-Man 2, like, that was pretty much, you know, I'm a nobody. Yeah. No one sees me, you know?
You're not like, a nobody. Do some stand-up. You'd be great at it.
Jules, and like, no, you're not a nobody. He's like, you know,
I thought it'd be cool if he got down and said, actually, you will be somebody. You will play a movie playing Ray Charles one day.
Yeah.
Yeah. He's like, I thought you were black. It's like...
You know that, Tommy? That tells me that there might be hope that they might do a live action of
I was just hoping you were black. Yeah. God. So you were hoping I was a nation Spider-Man.
Oh, no.
And by the way,
Spider-Man is not black. Oh.
And by the way, I'm saying this, you know, it's not because, you know, pertains to the black community. You know, because we need a black hero. Even though we got that already.
You got Blade. Shut up.
Well, you're not wrong.
Black Panther.
Yeah.
Exactly. Shut up. You got those guys.
A donation.
Spawn. Hell, you even have
a Spawn too.
You even have a black superhero. That Shaquille O'Neal played. What's it called?
There was even a Black Human Torch of Fantastic Four.
Oh no! Don't talk about
that. Although I'm gonna call that one Fantastic Boar, because it was.
It was. Go ahead, Robert.
Yeah, I can't remember the name of the movie that Shaquille O'Neal was in. He was also a superhero, but he was like some kind of steel man. It's not that. I can't remember.
Oh, that I forgot what it was, but oh my god,
I forgot too.
But Spawn, he's a black superhero.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I think it was more of like. I think it was more of like, you know, they were referencing Miles Morales, you know, saying, oh, there's got to be a black Spider-Man somewhere.
Yeah. And yes, yeah. Even though we got the anime one, you know, the Spider-Verse version of it, but we want to see live action. Yeah. You know, and it's not just, you know, to please the black community. Maybe most of them think that, but for us superhero, that draws Spider-Man. You know, if there's one thing that we need right now, is Miles Morales to do live action Spider-Man. Who that may be, I don't know.
Yeah, and not because he's black, because I don't care about that. All I care about is, hey, Miles is here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But yeah. But,
and this is when Green Goblin came. And he's like,
yes.
And because like he actually said a line, he actually said the exact same line he said to Toby. When Toby was like calling Mary Jane to see if she was okay, and like Green Goblin to the phone was like, "Oh, he's like, can Spider-Man come out to play?"
Like he said, "I love that."
Like, he goes, like he has his glider and he's throwing, you know, the razor bats and the bombs and stuff, and then dude, first of all, Doc Strange is there and he has the box, and like
Green Goblin tries. That's nothing. He came out of the Grand Canyon. Be stuck in there for 12 hours, I guess.
Yeah, it was 12 hours, yeah. But then he gets the box, but then there's a pumpkin bomb in there. It's like, oh, no. And then it explodes. Oh, what's up, Jordan?
What's up?
And then it explodes. And then And then you see like purple cracks in the sky, and like you see like silhouettes of like Spider-Man's, you know, villains. Like there was like
I'm sorry, those weren't purple cracks, man. I was smoking some weed. Those were purple haze.
It looks like, you know, some silhouettes of like, you know, Spider-Man villains. Like, because I saw some that looked like Rhino, that looked like Scorpion, that looked like Kraven the Hunter, like, you know, pretty much Spider-Man villains. That's what it looked like. Wow. Yeah. Yeah, because I look back at it, it's like, those are some, they look like some Spider-Man villains. So,
hey, maybe that's a message there. So unless that, you might see that in the future.
Yeah. So pretty much, like, if Strange didn't, like, didn't do that spell, there would be a whole lot more villains that Spider-Man can handle.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Oh, man, and this is when Tom and Goblin went at it. Like, when the shield... Yes. Like I said, this is when Tom Holland shined for me, bro. This is where you shine.
I just went and saw the goddamn movie today.
Oh, you saw it too?
Yeah.
You liked it?
Yeah, man.
It was great, man. That was lit. But yeah, man, Tom, bro, he gave it to Goblin, bro. Like, he was
fucking long are we gonna talk about this movie? Jesus Christ.
We're almost done.
It's longer than fucking WrestleMania.
it's more enjoyable than WrestleMania. I'll tell you that.
I'd rather watch paint dry in a wet turd.
Yeah, like, dude, Tom Holland's giving it to Green Goblin, bro. He is beating him down.
Giving it to Goblin.
And then he picks up his spider and he's about to stab it. Like, he's about to pull like a John Walker. Like, have you seen Falcon and Winter Soldier? You know, with the U.S. Agent of S.H.I.E.L.D.
What? Some did soldier. Yo, man, somebody's vibrator just came off, man. Change the batteries in that bitch.
Well, we'll pick on the glider with the, you know, giving the stab on Green Goblin.
Yeah.
I thought about some YouTuber saying, I'm going to stab you.
He was about to legit kill Goblin, but like Tom McGuire was like, no. He didn't say anything, but he was like, don't do this.
He winds up getting stabbed.
Yeah, but he was okay though. He was all right.
It was what you call this Spidey Shank.
Okay, now hold that thought. I was fucking pissed when they did that.
Dude, I was when it happened, like, we were shocked, like, no, do not kill Tom McGuire. Do not do that.
They should have made it a meme where, like, when he got stabbed, be like, surprise, thumb in the butt.
Oh, go ahead, Robert.
Yeah, because I was so excited to see Tobey Maguire coming back, you know, because he's, to me, is Spider-Man. Minus Andrew Garfield, because he's amazing too. No point intended.
Yeah.
But yeah, you see what
they did. Tobey Maguire is Spider-Man.
He's my childhood.
Fuck is Toby.
What?
What? Well, continue, Robert.
But yeah, when I saw that happen, you know, with the Green Goblin stabbing him, I'm like, I was getting pissed off. Like, no way, man, you're gonna kill him off? Yo, you mean tell me he's coming back to after all these years of being away of all this Spider-Man franchises, you're gonna kill him off?
I was like,
if they would have went through with that, the movie would, I would already put the movie on a zero.
I would. Oh my god!
I was gonna give this movie 10 cupcakes. Now you're getting half a cupcake. Fuck this!
I was gonna lose my fucking mind.
Dude, I was worried, they literally
teased that he's gonna die. Like, you motherfuckers! You're going back just to do that shit. That's fucking bullshit.
Also, what would have been the point of that?
Go ahead, Christian.
No, I was gonna say like, what would have been the point of like.
To piss off.
I mean, it was basically Green Goblin getting his revenge, but at the same time, you'd have fucked up the universe because he was not supposed to die. Like, no.
Hey, man, they really pushed the hell out of Green Goblin in this film.
I just realized.
I'll tell you what it was. It's to piss off all of us Tobey Maguire fans of Spider-Man. That's what it is, because we all keep talking about how Tom Holland is trash as Spider-Man, and this is their revenge on us. Fuck all y'all.
No, I like Tom more.
Yeah, I'm going. See it like that?
Yeah, I'm going. I'm going. I'm going. Yeah, I'm going there. I'm going there. I'm going to conspiracy theory. Fuck them.
Whatever. You're a fucking white supremacist. Fuck you.
What? Hey, yes, you want to call, hey, you want to call me a smart for Tobey Maguire? Then fine. I'm a fucking smart for Tobey Maguire.
Well, you beat me to it.
I didn't, like, yeah, like, trust me.
Motherfucker,
like,
fuck you. I'm going to kick your leg out of your leg.
Like, trust me, I was shocked when that happened, but I didn't really think it was like, oh, this is an FU since I didn't really see it like that.
Imagine they killed Toby in the end of the movie and somebody stepped on the credits and went, because fuck you, that's why.
they would have killed him. Yeah, that would have been really pissed off, but luckily he was okay. Like, he's like, he said, you know,
stabbed. Well, if this movie would have made by WWE Studios, they would have.
They wouldn't even have to worry. No, bro.
I would have been like Snoop Dogg, man. Fuck this shit, man.
Yeah. Fuck this shit. That's what I'm saying.
Hey, luckily he was okay. He just, you know, just got a stab wound.
God, I was pissed.
I was kind of scared, but hey.
It's like, oh my god, are you okay from that stab? Oh, I've had worse things happen to me. It's called Spider-Man 3. Anyways.
Oh, good.
But I think Andrew gave Tom the antidote for Goblin. I think it was him. Yeah,
Andrew
stabbed him in the neck. I was like, whoa! Like he got him right in the neck. I was like, oh yeah, that's the antidote. Right.
Well, yeah, he pretty much did it. He's like, oh shit, I better throw it to him. He's about to kill Goblin.
Yeah. So like,
In my mind, I'm thinking, oh no, Toby's gonna die. He's gonna fucking die because he got stabbed. But luckily, that didn't happen. I see myself, oh my god, thank god. If that would have fucking happened, I would have given this movie a fucking zero. A fucking zero.
Zero!
Yeah, so they didn't do that. Thank god it didn't. Yeah. But
now, if it was Tom Holland in that position, I would be like, yeah, finally they killed him.
I want to edit a picture instead of him stabbing Toby. It's like a DVD copy of Spider-Man 3.
Oh, that's messed up, man. But,
Now, Robert, you know, before the show, you asked me like, or you wish you would have, I would have been more angry about it.
Yeah.
When I first saw that, I'm thinking, wait a minute. But then I thought to myself, there's no way they're going to kill Toby off and then just have Andrew and Tom. Because if that would have happened, that would have happened. They kill Toby off. He comes back and just... We would not be the only ones that would have been pissed. I'm sure there would be plenty of other people.
I would have been the same way. I would have been like, "What is it? What is this?"
Yeah, people would have been pissed.
As soon as he got stabbed in the belly, all you see is Shaq falling to the table.
What the? But like I said, luckily they didn't do that. Yeah, Toby survived. He's strong.
I was fucking worried there.
Yeah, but then like. Normal Osborn went to normal, and he was saying, "What have I done?" Like, you know, much regretting everything. Like, he was like, "Man." And then I think this is when Tom Holland goes to Doctor Strange and says, "Like, redo the spell, but everyone forgets who I am. Everybody."
Yeah, yeah.
It's like, are you sure about this?
Don't worry, Tom. I already have.
So like, this is actually him taking responsibility. You know. Doing the hard choice and, you know, doing what's best for his loved ones.
It would have been cool if Deadpool would have pushed him out of the way, saying, "I need you to forget I need you to forget Green Lantern. Will you give him that?"
like I said to him before, she died. Great power comes with responsibility. He's finally learning. Yeah.
And before he before the spell happened, like he. It was so cool seeing all three Spider-Men hug each other, man. That was, like, so cool, bro.
Yeah.
Like, all three Spider-Men hugging each other. That was, like...
Another meme I would have loved to break down right there. Hug him!
They hugged and, you know... Tom went to Ned and MJ, you know, telling them what's going to happen. You know, they do their final goodbyes. You know, he finally gets a kiss from MJ, and then Doctor Strange does the spell, and you know, people forget Peter Parker is Spider-Man. Yep. Yeah, and other characters are sent back to the universe. So, yeah, and then Tom Holland he goes to the coffee shop where MJ and Ned is there.
Yeah,
he wants to tell her who he is, but then he sees the band-aid on her head. He realized that he doesn't want to get her hurt anymore, so he's like,
wanted to give her some more dick cheese at her local Dunkin' Donuts that she works at, but he couldn't do it.
So it's a hard choice in like saying, forget it.
No, I would have edited it where she was working at Burger King. He wouldn't even go in there. Oh gosh, she works at Burger King. Never mind.
But he makes the hard choice and just doesn't do it. And
I had to make a hard choice too. I had to watch Homecoming the second time.
Oh my god.
Hard choice for me.
But then he goes to his new apartment. He actually made his own stuff, which looks so awesome, by the way. Like I said, the spider logo, it looks like he took inspiration from both Andrew and Toby, which looks pretty awesome.
Again, he's running.
What gets me is they don't, Doctor Strange, if they want to see each other, visit each other, and chill out with all these Peters, they can go to each other's dimension and chill for a little bit. Won't harm nothing.
Yeah,
they could. But, yeah, so he does like his final swing, and like, this is like, yes. First of all, Andrew Garfield got his redemption. He got his redemption when he saved MJ. Mm-hmm. And Tom finally feeling like Spider-Man now. He finally feels like Spider-Man.
All time.
Yeah. So
shitty first movies to get to it. Oh.
So I heard
he's. And then he had to make his Spider-Man suit off Wish.
Oh, come on.
No, man. He had the original. It looked like he flew out of there with the Andrew suit on. It was pretty cool.
Yeah. That was cool. Yeah. He actually made his suit by, sewing it. It was cool, man. And I heard that Tom's going to have, like, another trilogy. I can't wait to see it now. I can't wait.
Crap.
It does. And I am curious where he goes from here. Because, he lost Aunt May. Everyone doesn't know who he is anymore because the memory's been wiped out by Doctor Strange. So,
the Deadpool scene where he was making his costume. Nothing beats that.
Oh man, yeah.
Sexy motherfucker.
No more Avengers. If he does decide to come back, because I hear he want to take a break from doing Spider-Man, whatever. But if he does come back, I am interested to see what where this Tom Holland version, but it took long enough to finally him to get it right.
Toby got out of that Spider-Man suit, boy, when he was done filming, he went on to Dairy Queen and like, fuck the diet, I'm good now.
What I've heard.
I want to see where at least two.
Yeah, what I've heard is
if you're ever gonna use a good kingpin, just use that cool kingpin they use in the Daredevil series. He's a good kingpin.
They're gonna use him. They're gonna do it.
Yes.
Speaking of which,
Matt, his
Matt Murdock?
He was in there. He was the lawyer and shit, yeah.
The lawyer.
Because he caught something and shit. He was like, how'd you do that?
I'm a good lawyer.
Yeah, because what I've learned is that Daredevil's radar sense is better than Spider-Man's spider sense. Yeah, so that's how he was able to do that.
Yeah, man, I wouldn't mind another Daredevil movie.
Hell yeah. Okay, and maybe Tom Holland's, as Spider-Man, maybe his Spider Sense got more. Maybe he's gonna learn on to meet more of that.
Yeah, because Spider-Man now he has no Avengers. Like he's gonna meet more like street level heroes, like Daredevil, Luke Cage possibly, mm-hmm. Iron Fist maybe. Like he's gonna be more street level. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So, I can see him face Kingpin because Spider-Man has faced Kingpin,
Got a universe where, here's the fucked up universe. It would have fucking Ben Affleck show back up as Daredevil. Oh, crap.
Oh, no. No.
I highly doubt they would even do that since Ben he's in freaking DC, so I doubt it.
Well, I mean,
That's even worse, too.
They would have the Avengers and both Fantastic Four teams showed up like, send them back. They both suck. Get them out of here. Wait. Jessica Alba looks good in that tight suit. Hold on for a second. Let me...
What they need, okay, what, so they need, what they need to do is get a second another chance to actually do it right with Fantastic Four.
I swear to God, dude, when they reboot that shit for the third damn time and they fuck it up, if they fuck it up again, give it up. Throw it away. Give it up.
Yeah, just give it up.
I actually have faith in MCU
I don't know. Two fucking strikes out. How could the second how could the second one be worse?
Well, I don't know.
Like, MCU... fucking Doctor Doom looked like a chewed up piece of fucking damn Skittles, dude.
Oh, don't remind me of that, man. That was freaking terrible.
Dude, you look fucked up, dude. Like, straight the fuck up, man. It looked like a dude addicted to too much crack rock. I was like, what the fuck is up with him?
And the thing wasn't wearing pants?
No, yeah, the thing was butt-ass fucking naked, man. He didn't even have a cock. You know what would have been so worse? I would have hated the fact that I was a rock character, but I would have looked down and said, wait a minute, I'm made out of rock and I don't have a dick? Oh, fuck, kill me. I'm done.
I wasn't going that far.
Yeah, I was going
to
say...
No, like, I would, man. Come on now. I become some rock thing. That's bad enough. I look down, my Johnson's gone. Oh, fuck my life.
Oh, my God.
I was about to say, like... Cause, like,
can't even take blue chew.
The thing is, like, the thing actually looked good in the movie. Like, he actually looked like a rock monster. The problem is, yeah, he didn't wear no pants. It's like, it's just weird wearing no pants.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I have faith in MCU. I think they can make it work, you know, because honestly, they've made a lot of great movies in MCU, you know. Captain America, Iron Man,
Avengers.
Guardians of the Galaxy.
I'm ready for it. I'm ready for fucking Guardians of the Galaxy 3. Big time.
They made a lot of great movies, so I have some faith.
I'm looking forward to Doctor Strange 2.
Oh, Doctor Strange 2. Oh, yeah. Because Sam Raimi's going to direct it.
Fuck all these damn movies, dude. I want a Powdered Toast Man movie.
Yes.
That's what I want. Powdered Toast Man with his butt cheeks flying in the air going backwards.
For Ren and Stimpy.
Oh, fuck yeah, Powder Toast Man, man. He joins the Avengers and shit. He's flying Ant-Man in the back of his ass.
Yeah, so I heard the director is going to be Sam Raimi, the guy who did this.
And every time they release a bad Marvel movie, just have the horse go, no, sir, I don't like it.
Mm-hmm. I can't wait to see it, man. MCU is winning, bro. It's winning. They're winning.
Yeah, they're winners.
And they got Disney on this side.
Yeah.
Hey,
MCU is a winner.
I'm telling you, man. What if they had a movie with Michael Jordan in it, and they went, you know what that means? Jordan was a winner.
Yeah. Eddie Brock showed up with
Venom. Yeah.
The post movie.
Yeah, and he was pretty much, you know, asking, there was a Hulk, there's the Avengers, Thanos, like, what?
Okay, you said he left a little symbiote behind, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he left a little bit of
symbiote. Okay, then you know that's going to get on Spider-Man. It's quite obvious.
Oh, yeah, Black Spider-Man's coming, so we already know,
Tom's going to be like, oh my God, I'm black now, I'm with the homies. Yeah. Oh my God, where's my Booker T cup? Oh, man.
Oh man! But yeah, that's what I'm looking forward to more. To see where Tom Holland goes from here. But tends to introducing Venom in there.
Yeah, really, really good movie, man. Really good, bro. Fantastic movie. I had a blast watching this in the movie theaters with my brother and my dad. It was so great.
Basically, it was the Fantastic Three, Spider-Man's.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, dude, that was amazing, bro. No pun intended, but it was.
Yeah,
it was amazing. It was spectacular. Like, it was everything I thought was gonna be, and a little more. It was just like so great.
You got all over Green Goblin's ass, big time. Spider-Man, whipped your ass as fast as I can.
The only thing that was a little nitpick for me is that there was no Harry Osborn.
Your ass, a bastard skull. I made you piss and shit in your overalls.
That would have been great if James Franco actually. The return for this one.
Mm-hmm. At least they didn't mention him.
Oh, cool. If he would have showed up as the character he played in the movie The Room, that'd have been great.
Oh no.
That'd be good. Oh, hi Mark.
Man, hey, at least they didn't mention him, so
yeah. The story was wrong how they mentioned it.
Well, no, I was talking about when
Imagine Franco showed up on the glider and shit and he came out as the wrong character. He was the character from Pineapple Express.
Oh. No, I was talking about when Norman Osborn was talking about him.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, like when he said, like, you know, Osborn's not here, my son's not here.
No, he was freaking out because he's thinking, wait a minute, I don't have a job here? Dude, I'm broke. This sucks. Yeah, yo, am I going to be able to live with you and Bane on May or something?
I
got to do something for fucking work, man. There ain't no Oscorp here. I'm fucked.
Yeah, that's true.
The fuck do you do for work around here? I used to work for Iron Man. Oh, who's that? Never mind.
Well, he can work at Stark Industries, you know. He can make a lot of pumpkin bombs and gliders.
Oh, cool. I get to make my own iron goblin suit. Hey. Wait a minute, can you imagine an Iron Man suit all green, like it looked like a Green Goblin suit? Imagine how kind of sick that would look.
That would look sick. That would definitely look sick.
Pumpkin Bob's coming off a hand and shit. He'd be fucking people up.
Yeah, that'd be awesome.
Iron Goblin, yeah!
Iron Goblin.
Yeah, right. Kick your fucking ass.
That's my thing to it.
Iron Goblin. But... yeah, fuck you.
But yeah, as far as No Way Home, it's way more better than Far From Home and Homecoming.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. This is definitely a movie for all three generations for Spider-Man fans, you know.
Way better than Far From Good and Shortcoming.
Yeah. Like I said, I think if Homecoming...
Yeah, right. Fuck Far From Good and fuck Boring.
Far From Home, nah, I still can't. Nah, I can't forgive that, man. That was terrible.
It's better than Monday Night Raw Homecoming.
What the fuck ain't better than Monday Night Raw and shit, motherfucker?
Hey, shit.
I would rather play fucking oh shit. I forgot. I'd rather play, you know, the what was the one with the WB cars, the game?
Crush Hour?
I'd rather play
Crush Hour than fucking one in Montreal at all.
All right, there you go.
I guess we can talk about Owen Hart.
That's saying a lot because that game was pure dog shit.
Oh, come on, that was great.
Are you high?
No, I'm not.
That game sucked donkey dicks.
Come on, you know what the game was about.
There was nothing Omega about that piece of shit. That game sucked.
It was about shooting your opponents, you know, and everything, you know. It was like Carmelo. What the fuck, man?
that's if you got Twisted Metal with a $5 budget. Fuck that.
Yeah, that's how I feel like it was. It was like Twisted Metal.
No, that was the bitch of Twisted Metal. I would rather play Twisted Metal. No, Swisher Metal Small Brawl. I can't tell which one was worse.
It was something new. Yeah, that's what he did. Which I have to appreciate.
Something sucked. Anyways.
But I guess
I'm not saying it's the greatest thing yet, but I enjoyed it.
It's like, shit. Would you rather play that or watch repeat mode Billy Chuck's entrance? Oh shit, they both suck.
Crush Hour.
That is
Crush Hour.
So good to me.
No.
Nope.
All right, so I guess we're talking about Owen Hart now.
Well, one more.
All right, let's kick some legs out of some legs, boys.
One more thing.
Enough is enough, and it's time for a change.
Exactly.
There's one more thing I wanted to say about this. As great as it was,
yeah,
I would have loved to have seen at the end a final swing between all three Spideys.
That would have been cool.
That was my only gripe, is when they disappeared, that wasn't like the disappear I kind of wanted. I wanted to get more of a... Or you know, that, or show all three of them in their own universes swinging.
That would have been actually cool.
Yeah. Definitely.
That actually would have been cool to see. Like, all three of them, like a split screen of them swinging. That would have been cool, actually.
And then Toby swings towards the screen with the black suit on and goes, yeah! Yeah, you're going to cry! And then ends.
I love that song.
You'll get your rent when you fix this damn door, asshole. Damn, dude. Chill out.
But yeah, let's talk about some Owen Hart.
So, yes. If anyone has not, you know, picked up what happened on Rampage, you know, obviously it wasn't, you know, much of a big announcement of it. They didn't have enough time to do so because, you know, they had other programs to do on there, but they did you know, let us know that the Owen Hart tournament, to honor the late great Owen Hart, that the tournament's gonna be happening around May, which could be you know, doing up for Double or Nothing. It's not gonna be just involving the men's in this tournament, but it goes involve women in the tournament as well.
And as soon as they said, please let it be on May 19th.
I guess Double or Nothing could, but if it's on a Saturday or Sunday, whichever goes.
Well, you—it's a Owen Hart. Oh God, I just figured this out. That's gonna be an Owen Hart tournament. Yeah. You know what they're gonna say about that, yeah, right? They're gonna say, "I bet you any money you're gonna have some motherfucker saying they're ripping that off from the Warrior Awards and shit." I'm like, ugh.
Well, I haven't seen any of that yet. Which is a Warrior Award, but there have been some people that
I just predict these WWE fanboys and what they say. You know, it's just they always want to find something to say somebody's ripping off WWE.
Yeah, as always. But yeah, they have been some negative online, which I'll get to. You know, I'm not going to get to all of them. You know, but now, as far as when they announced the women's premiere, I was thinking, oh no, we're going to see Brandi Rose, we're going to see Penelope Ford, we're going to see another Rose and a Bunny.
Oh, if Brandi Rose enters, I hope she wins.
I'm like, oh no, don't.
Actually, oh, I'm actually hoping Cody and Brandi both win the Rhodes tribute.
No, no. Well, actually, I was thinking about Cody. It's Cody's in there. I'll be all right with Cody. You know, but I want him to win though. But still,
adrenaline in my soul, kicking your leg out of your other leg.
Yeah, but yeah, I can't wait for this tournament.
Hell yeah, man! Now we know one thing. Who's not gonna be in this tournament? Kevin Owens. We'll get to him later. But
fuck him.
Yes. But as far as this announcement was made, Owen Hart, the winner of the tournament from both sides of the women and men will be presented by the widow, Martha Hart. Now, obviously, I'm pretty sure you also have OJ and Athena Hart, you know, the children of Owen. It's a fortunate number. I don't think we'll have Bret Hart there. I think if he's available, David Boy Smith Jr. if he shows up, but I don't know if there's any ill will with Tyson Martha and David Boy, but you know, David Boy Jr. I should say, but Bret Hart and Martha, they had some falling out at one point, but hopefully they could put that aside, to see how it turns out once we get to the one thing of who may be winning it. But yeah, either way, I'm happy they're doing this thing. Now to say this. As much as that, we're happy about this, because either way, it doesn't matter what company is honoring Owen Hart, of his legacy, his memory, because in WWE we can't have that, because let's be honest, it's their fault, not because of his death, but how they handle his death, and how they dishonor the widow's wishes afterwards, is why. That Martha Hart doesn't want anything to do with the WWE of honoring to acknowledge Owen Hart on WWE programming, where it tends to put him in video games, merchandises, Hall of Fame, and everything. Which of course this one person on Twitter who said, "Oh, Martha Hart is the reason why that Owen Hart's not in the WWE Hall of Fame." No, the WWE is the reason why that Owen Hart is not in the Hall of Fame. It's the WWE is the reason why that he's not around anymore. It's WWE is the reason why that they decided to go against her wishes and her honor with regards to everything that happened afterwards. It's WWE's fault that they sue her. I guess if you may not know about this, they sue Martha Hart after having of Owen. If anyone's to blame that Owen Hart is not being honored in WWE, it's the WWE. Because they allowed Owen Hart to die on their watch because of that stupid fucking stunt that should have never been done in the fucking first place.
That's right.
Yeah, use with different equipment.
Yeah, and equipment that's used for a sailboat.
Irresponsible.
That's how I check. Owen Hart's not a fucking sailboat.
Nope.
But yeah, these people are, they just can't be happy of of any company other than WWE to honor the man, because Martin Hart refuses to work with them, are responsible for his death. Not saying that it was on purpose. Obviously, it was an accident.
Yeah, I just don't get why they're so upset that other companies are honoring Owen Hart. It's like, you do realize he has wrestled in other companies other than WWF, right?
Yeah. Oh, but because he's not wrestling in AEW, that's one of the reasons too. Yeah. Why they honor on this man in AEW? He's never been in AEW.
Well,
you could say that a lot with all the other wrestlers that they're not wrestling WWE and they were honoring WWE.
Yeah, and besides, like I'm pretty sure they've honored Dusty Rhodes in AEW. He's never been in AEW.
No. Obviously, with Cody Rhodes and Tony Schiavone and Dustin Rhodes. I don't count Brandi Rhodes.
Yeah, but like, you know what I'm saying? It's like, bro, you do realize there's some legends that can still be honored in different companies, right? It's not just, everything. Like, it's not just a single company thing.
It's a wrestling business.
Yes. Yeah. Because at the end of the day, Owen Hart was a pro wrestler at the end of the day.
Yeah, they can honor Rick Rude, in AEW if they wanted to.
Yeah, they want to. Now, here's the thing. If at the time the TNA was always around, if they wanted to honor Owen Hart, because Jeff Jarrett, who's a longtime friends with Owen Hart, if you would want to mark the Hart, and if you want to honor Owen Hart, in TNA wrestling during that period of time, retains to have their own tournament, that would mean great. But retains to WWE fans, thinking, why this company is doing it, even though he's never been in that company before, he should do it in WWE because he's been in WWE. It'll be the same pattern of like what's going on right now.
Yeah, it'd be the same thing.
Even if Ring of Honor was doing a tournament for Owen Hart, retains to working beside with Martha Hart, where they could have done a tournament where they could have called the Owen of Honor or the Ring of Owen, whatever they want to do on behalf of Owen Hart.
The Ring of Hart.
I think that would have been cool. But then you get these WWE fans. He should be honored only in WWE and blah blah blah. Again, same pattern like this one right now with AEW.
Yeah,
it's always gotta be in one company. Well, if that's the case, then how about New Japan Pro Wrestling do one then? New Japan Pro Wrestling, Owen Hart, they came from there. He wrestled in the Best of the Super Juniors during his time, and he was great during those times too. Former IWGP Junior Heavyweight Champion.
Yeah, they can't say, Owen Hart was never in New Japan. He was.
Yeah.
What are we talking about?
and I'll never forget this one person who because AEW is doing something with Owen Hart.
What, your butt?
And I'll never forget this one person on Twitter, who said, the WWE should sue AEW for honoring Owen Hart.
WW like E or something could suck my nuts.
I'm a finance manager.
Oh God, not that asshole.
You said ass. He's a panty waste.
And yeah, if I remember, I said which was a funny thing. That some people thought I said. Yeah, when I heard about him being a finance manager, I was like, well, go to him doing my fucking finances.
Me and Beavis don't even pay ours.
But yeah, these are the type of people that are out there that tends to talk all this nonsense. Tends to other companies do stuff for own heart and not with WWE. Well, guess what? Tough shit. If WWE would have done right with Owen Hart after his death, maybe he would have been honored.
Yeah. WWE are full of fart knockers. they didn't even Owen Hart. Well, Owen something? Damn it, I can't read this.
And think of the last memory of Owen Hart when he died. He was the Blue Blazer because of a stunt. that they did with him. I know it. Over
that
there.
Was a stupid gimmick.
My last memory was Owen Hart kicking Beavis's ass.
But as far as the Owen Hart stuff that they do for him, New Japan Pro Wrestling is going to allow AEW to some video footages on behalf, because Rocky Romero talked to him about it too, and I think they're going to show it on Dynamite later on tonight. I think they are. I don't know. That's what I heard. I think that's what they're doing. But yeah. Either way, it's great that they're doing this with Owen Hart, because we haven't heard not everyone heard of him for so long. Because only in WWE, and only WWE matters, right?
What the hell is that crap?
Because the WWE is the end all be all, the be all end all of wrestling companies, right?
No, it's not.
It's only company to go to.
You said and.
It's the only company to be unrecognized in the world, right? No, it's not. There's other wrestling companies out there too.
It's probably bigger than Mr. Anderson's butt.
But yeah, that's all I got to say, guys. Over there, which is the whole thing. I'm excited for the Owen Hart tournament. For a long time Owen Hart fan like me, especially how heartbroken I was when he died on WWE's behalf. How they handled it too and all. They don't deserve to honor Owen Hart, and I'm glad that he's being honored by AEW. So there you go.
Yeah, AEW like rules or something. Me and Beavis are gonna be all elite.
Actually, that's not bad.
We're gonna beat the crap out of the Young Bucks. They're a bunch of wussies.
Yes, do that. Yes.
Young Bucks suck. Shut up, Beavis.
The dream.
Trying to talk.
The dream match.
Butthead is all elite. shut up.
That should be a t-shirt.
But yeah, what's got to say?
Beavis is nut say? Rag.
Oh god, I'm pretty sure he's got a lot on. Because we're never gonna score.
Yeah, Beavis stays up all night. He still hasn't gotten any. We're gonna get with like Tecante, and we're gonna touch her. We're gonna get with like that chick that looked like a rooster, that Ruby.
Ruby
Soho.
Apparently,
yeah, Ruby so butt.
Is either that or an ostrich.
Oh God.
Beavis's mom.
I heard that too. By the way. Before I let you guys go, talk about more on Hart, I also gotta say this to this person on Twitter as well, saying that AEW exploiting Owen Hart on this whole thing. I say myself, how are they exploiting Owen Hart? If they're not going on there weekly or monthly talking about Owen Hart, if you want to talk about exploitation of a wrestler's death, WWE did that with Eddie Guerrero.
Oh yeah. Remember the whole thing in 2006?
Yeah. They did that constantly, even in 2005.
Let's face it, Robert. Anything they fucking do that prior's honoring a legend, they're all going to make some excuse of, this company's doing it for this, and it's all some excuse. But if WWE did it, everybody wouldn't, they wouldn't give a shit.
Yeah. Even when it comes to Brody Lee, I say to myself, well, of course, I'm going to talk a little bit about Brody Lee, because Brody Lee was from AEW. His memory of his last year was in AEW and his family.
Because in the E, all you get is fucking nothing but, here's a fall of fame when you pass away. Here's some action figures and merch. There you go. You're done.
Yeah. Now with Brody Lee, they'll mention him that often, but whenever they feel the need to mention Brody Lee, they would. Is that called exploitation? No. These people, I'm telling you, man, it's just be happy that they're honoring Burley, and be happy that Owen Hart's being honored too.
Sounds like somebody's watched some violent movies. What are you watching, butthole?
But yeah, there you go. That's what I said for today. So,
shut up.
Okay, I'm gonna shut up now. And you guys talk about one part now about this.
Yeah, let me talk, fart knocker. Owen Hart or something. Kicking legs out of legs.
I am happy that they're doing this tournament.
And yeah. AEW rules.
Yes. Glad that they're honoring Owen Hart and WWE doesn't deserve to even get the chance to even mention it. They wanted to of Owen Hart.
They are doing something good. Yep. They really are. It's a good thing they're fucking doing it. None of this whole they're exploiting it. Go spoil these nuts. Fuck you.
Exactly.
Can't stand that fucking shit. Anytime another company does it, it's bad. But WWE does it, it's good.
How many times do these people exploit charity? How many times do they use John Cena to exploit?
How many times a motherfucker is going to make up some dumbass excuse for another company every single time they do something nice for a legend? There's always some motherfucker that's going to come out the woodworks and say, they're doing this, they're doing this. Shut the fuck up.
They did it with a warrior, too.
Exactly.
Oh, but now if you say that, they'll just say, no, they were honoring him. That's what this company's doing. But it's kid, because it's not the E doing it, it's bad.
It's a wrestling community. That's what they should do.
All right.
Exploit. Make full use of and derive benefit from a resource.
What?
That's what exploit means.
We know what it means, Spark. You know what I mean?
So, how is AEW using them for their benefits, per se?
Because we said so.
That's not what the definition is. Okay.
It's for me.
That's what you think about this. If Owen Hart were to go in the Hall of Fame, it's not about, you know, honoring the man. It's about making money off of him. Because that's what the Hall of Fame is all about. That's all the Hall of Fame is.
That's where Vince fucks up. It's like, what's wrong with that? I mean, shit. Hold on.
And the whole thing with Ultimate Warrior, you know, since we mentioned Ultimate Warrior, when he refused to go to the Hall of Fame back in 2005, whatever, when they wanted to do a DVD about him, you know, nice, you know, say good things about him, and he refused. So what they do? They did a DVD burying the guy. So unless you work with them and sign a contract with them, you know, be in good trust with them, they'll put you in the Hall of Fame and make money out of you and say, oh yeah, this guy's great. But if you don't, they'll do a DVD burying you and like, oh yeah, this guy's an abomination, blah blah blah, like he's, you know, he. And they'll blackball you at the end of the day.
Well, that's the definition of exploit. When they buried him, that was exploiting.
And Warrior saw that, and it kind of hurt him to see that.
Yeah, it did.
Yeah.
Are you talking about that bullshit self-destruction DVD?
Yep.
Yeah.
Oh god, yeah, that DVD can wipe my ass with that. Let's not talk about you, Terry, with your fucking fanny pack full of cocaine.
Exactly.
You know, Terry, you're back there being a piece of shit and you're sharing your wife.
Didn't they do that with Randy Savage too?
Yeah, they made my offense too. And even though this man didn't want him in there, it's that's the thing too. This man will only put you in the Hall of Fame if whenever he says so. Guarantee you, if Austin were not call him out on when they first did the Stone Cold podcast,
or if you pass away, you're automatically in the Hall of Fame when you pass away.
Yeah, and which I'm still waiting for Vader and King Kong Bundy and Bam Bam Bigelow to go in there, and they have yet gone in there yet. But Randy Savage, you know, Vince McMahon, you know, had no choice but to put him in the Hall of Fame after Austin called him out on him in 2014. And then once 2015 came around, you know, Austin watched him as in the Hall of Fame. Other than that, you know, if it wasn't for Stone Cold mentioning the name, we would have never gotten a Macho Man in the Hall of Fame.
They should have put China in the Hall of Fame when she was alive.
Yeah.
No, she did porn.
No. What? So, well, okay.
Sonny.
So we're gonna put.
Who the fuck is that?
So we're gonna put Hulk Hogan.
That's the girl that got with. That's the girl that got with Shawn Michaels. That was me. Ugh. Oh, what were you saying, Nick?
So we're gonna put Hulk Hogan, who said some racist stuff.
Yes.
Did some sex videos into the Hall of Fame. It's, you know.
Hey.
Okay, that's
his sex video didn't get released. Okay, and I stand behind his racism.
Of course you do.
And he's the Hulkster, damn it! Yeah, come on.
Wait.
Yeah, the real American.
But you kicked him out.
Fuck.
exactly.
Damn it! Where the hell's Garrett Bischoff when I need him? Garrett Bischoff. Yeah, I mean. Shit. I don't know. Fuck. Yeah, well, Terry's a shit. He made Hulkamania. Come on, he had Hulkabears, asshole. Did you have a Hulkabear?
Hulkabear.
Hulkabear.
Yeah.
Dude, I've never heard of an Asylum Bear. Fuck off.
And there's also a Pasta Mania that failed.
Yeah. Yeah, where's that? Marik and Jay Pasta, huh? Yeah, Hogan made that, yeah. That's right. Yeah, Terry didn't have to complain. Shit. Yeah, Terry, tell Brooke Hogan to call me.
Yeah, he didn't have to explain anything, because you fired him.
Fuck.
Yeah.
Fuck. Shit. I still sell his merch though. It counts for something.
Good.
I mean, it kind of does.
Well, the fact of the matter is, they kicked Hogan out not because of the sex tape. So.
Well, I was hoping he would be all elite, but they changed their mind about that shit.
Good.
Yeah, the sex tape was whatever. It's what he said in the sex tape was why they kicked him out.
Yeah. Oh, well, he felt like a pig, brother. Yeah, hey, you know what's one thing about that sex tape? Damn, Hogan had a white ass in that tape. Yeah, Harry's been wearing those fucking orange, those yellow trunks all his life. He was sleeping. He never takes the damn tape off. Like, Terry, take off your damn tights. I want to see your ass when it's tan. Oh, yeah, Hulkabutt. Oh.
Hulkabutt.
Yeah, Hulkamania, Vince McMahon running wild in that ass. With my do-rag on, yeah.
Yeah.
Shut up, yeah.
I'm going to show you my secret weapon, a pencil. Yeah.
Here's my secret weapon, eat a dick.
The point, it's not the pointy part, it's the other part, the eraser. Yeah.
Yeah, pencil. Got a little surprise for you, yeah. You take guess what that is? Yeah. They sure the fuck ain't make fall into Santa suit, yeah.
Have you guys heard about that, by the way? The whole thing with this man put out a pencil with Austin Theory?
No.
It was the weirdest thing. I didn't see it, but I heard about it. It was the weirdest thing ever. Like, a pencil? Like, my God, this guy's lost it. He's really lost it. Like...
Yeah, like I lost the budgets that I cut.
Well, yeah. I guess we move on next topic now. Mm-hmm. So what's going on with Mike Kyoto talking about Triple H and Shane McMahon, Christian?
Okay, let me find the article.
Oh, fuck my Yoda.
Yeah, I gotta hear about this with Triple H. He's a triple eagle, triple bitch.
Why does everything have to involve Paul?
Triple heart attack.
You should be happy. He's your son. Oh,
fuck him.
Because I'm the gamer.
Yeah, I'm like Walt Disney. I live forever. Fuck him.
the game of triple heart attacks.
Yeah, fuck him. Looking like he had too many strokes. Fucking Sniffle H.
Mike Kyoto was asked if anybody advised Triple H to not date Stephanie back in the day. Kyoto said Shane McMahon did, which led to Triple H having heat with him for 10 years.
Yeah, I was going to kick his ass.
Here's what Kyoto said. Yeah, Shane McMahon did. That's why the feud fell out, that's for sure. It was a thing from Vince Sr. that came around many years ago. They didn't want anybody dating talent. None of the kids and none of their family. He didn't want them taking bumps, which that didn't happen. I think Shane really had a big part of that, and that's why Shane and Triple H had a falling out for many years, and that's why Shane was exiled for 10 years. So it's because of Triple H. Okay, cool.
Well, for one, you're boning my sister while you're cheating on China. It's basically like dating your boss, you know? Of course people are going to say, that can end pretty bad, dude, because if you hurt her,
yeah.
Not good.
Let's see. Shane is still not at the top of the list where he's at now. Is he in the office? Is he running things? Is he vice president? Is he CEO? Can somebody tell me where he's at right now? Because he should be there. I mean, even with Triple H out, you're going to have Johnny Laurinaitis, Road Dogg, it's got, okay? You're not going to have Shane McMahon there. Where is he at? It boggles me for years, too. A lot of heat there. It gets more interesting, believe me. It's sad because when I started working for the company, there was Linda McMahon, Vince, Shane, Stephanie, and now it seems to be all broken now. All the money in the world probably can't fix it. They have all the money in the world, a publicly traded company, which is okay. The family's torn apart at this point, I think. Maybe not torn apart all the way, which I hope not, but it's torn apart.
And that was it?
Yeah, it was pretty much about Shane and Triple H.
Well, like I said, your big brother, you know, worried about some wrestler dating her sister. Think about it. She's the owner's daughter. I'm the brother. Of course I'm going to think, oh, he's only dating you, honey, because you know who you are.
Yeah. They've had heat.
You probably looked at him, too, saying, come on, Stephanie, he was terrorizing. Why the fuck would you date that?
Terrorizing.
Yeah, I feel that way too. Yeah, it is crazy though that Triple H was with China, and then all of a sudden he started off getting with Stephanie, and that pretty much ruined the relationship and also ruined the life of China, because Triple H was getting nowhere, and I'm saying that in facts, nowhere.
Yeah, it kind of pisses me off because I love how we're all worried about Shane's feelings and fucking Stephanie's feelings, but we're just forgetting all about China's feelings, though. You know? Yeah.
It's ridiculous, man. That Triple H is in the position that he is because he cheated on with China to get with the boss's daughter, and now to see how that the family is falling apart because of that.
Sure, I swear, man, only during the storylines where Harris was with Triple H and Stephanie that actually looked affectionate. When you see him in public mm-hmm. and shit, he looks like he doesn't want to be around her.
Yeah, I heard that.
Don't touch my fucking head. I had to do Blade Trinity the Chaperone. I'm pissed off enough.
What?
There's even like a video like named Triple H annoyed with Stephanie. Like, there's actually like a video named that.
Let's hope to God those daughters of his look more like the mommy than the daddy. Jesus. Oh. The daughters that look like Triple H? Oh no.
I also heard one of the daughters are, you know, I think she's getting, I don't know how old she is, but I think she wants to be in the business. You know, with, I think.
Of course she does. And she will automatically get a spot because of who daddy is.
Yeah.
Just like Rock's daughter. They're all going to have a spot. It's all going to be a new generation.
Yeah. Which is not, not wrong with that.
Can you dig it?
Let's just hope Stone Cold never has a daughter that looks. Let's have Stone Cold. Stone Cold got kids?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's got kids. He's got daughter.
Let's hope to God the girls don't look like him. Maybe look like Stunning Steve Austin with blonde hair. It wouldn't look right.
I don't remember how she looks.
I think the only one that got too much of the dad's looks was Brock's daughter. Ugh.
Oh.
Yeah.
Well, yeah. Other than that, yeah, Triple H. You know. There's still also to talk about the change of Triple H. You know, that involves Ric Flair, but that'll be another time. But because that also has a little Bryan Danielson too. But Triple H ain't shit. And it works right. He's on shit in first because he's you know, Dane the Boss. This door.
Yeah, it's real funny. Ain't shit telling me that I ain't shit.
That's why he's got what 14 title reigns, I think.
Yeah, I made the shepherd. What have you done?
Yeah, because I can lose shit.
Needs a lot, Spark.
Oh yeah, means a lot. That was pretty DVD.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, what did CM Punk tell you that? Fuck him.
What?
Smoke.
You know, it's funny. These movies that that they do for WWE, that they watch on DVD, not once none of that has appeared on TV.
Wow.
Well, let's see. If I did the Moroccan Marine in 12 rounds, I wouldn't want them to be on fucking TV either. Fucking Marine sucks dick. All of them do.
But yeah, well, props to my killer for, for doing that interview pertains to Triple H and Shane McMahon's, issues. And I don't fault Shane McMahon. You know, Shane McMahon felt differently about the whole thing with Triple H, you know, especially he was with China and now he's with his sister. Yeah, I'll be in that same position too.
Somebody watching Gossip Girls, Real Housewives?
Oh, no, I'm watching George Lopez.
Oh, okay. Oh. And then Jewish cats are attack.
Well, better than Drake and Josh.
Oh, come on. Why are we bringing that up?
Ugh, it's not like somebody ripped a fart.
Oh, God. And then Jewish had a heart attack again.
Oh.
Wait a minute, he's had more than one?
No, he didn't.
Oh, I was going to say. I was like, damn.
I'm just being a dick.
No, I would believe it if you kept saying he's had a couple strokes because his face is just drooping real bad.
Yeah, no, he's aging pretty bad now.
Damn, when you look rougher than Sonny's fucking OnlyFans, that's bad.
Oof.
Ugh.
All right, and I guess we move on to Mark Henry now. I saw the video about Mark Henry. What's going on with that whole thing? But Christian, what can you tell us about Mark Henry? About what you said to me?
Yeah, that he was booked in a match against Sin Cara, I believe.
Sin Cara.
Oh, okay. And he didn't come out to face Mark Henry because, like, they did it on purpose. Like it was kind of like a rib on Mark Henry, and Mark Henry got really pissed by it. Like, they just randomly did that, you know.
Well, what the hell was that? Well, if you remember kind of color his skin is, why do you think I did it?
Oh, my God.
Well, I guess you're good that you're honest about it.
Oh, wait. No, shit. Forget what I said.
So, yeah. This man was apologetic of it, and like, I don't give a fuck. But then, you know, they, in a way, they made up for him for being world champion. Yeah, and the whole, you know, the whole Hall of Fame, I meant to say. I guess that was supposed to be a way where they want to see him, more anger of him, and, you know, give him that push. Basically, the WWE's your way by testing them, which is weird how they do it. Just to push him to a point where, okay, now we can push this guy, you know, because he's got showing some fire, you know, by what, ribbing him like that? What the fuck kind of business mindset you have there?
Yeah, like, well, when you just push him, like, push him, like,
just, yeah, like, just push him.
Well, like a push, a good push, or like a Zack Ryder off stage push?
Yeah, like, that was a diggish move by them.
And Walker was quick because of that too.
Yeah.
Well, it doesn't matter anyways. He's in AW now, so. And the best thing about Walker is him saying it's time for the main event.
Yeah.
I wonder if he's gonna wrestle.
I don't know if he is.
Hell, we saw Paul White in my way. That was not fun. That was not fun at all, seeing Paul White wrestle. Especially with me, seeing him wrestle live on AW. And like, it wasn't bad, but like, this isn't the same Paul White anymore that everyone's seen before. Obviously, because, you know, he had that, I think that middle plate is hip whatever or hip replacement. I can't remember what it was. I'm pretty sure it was a hip replacement, but either way, yeah, this ain't the same part that we saw years ago. What's the point of wrestling in AEW? I don't mind him being a commentator though, with his doing elevations. Which, by the way, Mark Henry should be a commentator for Rampage. Yo, that was the idea first when they announced Rampage. He did it for a little bit because Chris Jericho had to be a fucking dick and take over. Oh, it's gotta be about him.
Well, and now Mercury's back. And now
Mercury's backstage is doing backstage interviews. I mean, he was doing that before too and all, but that's been his job now. Also, like, come on, Mercury can do more than that. Because, yo, like he said before in the past, he's got left in the tank. Come on. All right, that's just me. All right, I guess we can talk about Jeff Hardy. He's fine, guys. He's fine.
Yeah, I heard about that.
Okay, so let's recap what happened with Jeff Hardy. It was in December 4th, I believe. He was in the house show of a six-man tag match. You know, he was teaming with Drew McIntyre and King Woods against the Bloodline. Jeff Hardy, what some people were saying, he looked sluggish in a way, and like he's probably he was probably drinking and all that. You know, that ended up not being the case. I don't know why he's acting those questions and all that. I don't know why he did what he did. Or Jeff Hardy knows. But will he tell us that eventually in the future? It's up to him. But then he made the hot tag to Drew McIntyre. He left into the crowd. Streets following with him. And he's in the middle of the crowd. Selfies, pictures and all that, posting for the fans and all that. And the screen right there with him. Make sure nothing happens. You know. And then that's when, WWE, because they saw a video, they're assuming that he may have relapsed or maybe he was drinking while wrestling. But there was reports of it that he didn't drink in the law. And we don't know what the drugs, the test of his drugs or, if he's on drugs. I don't think he relapsed. And they say he was not drunk while wrestling, which they ruled it by saying something about he was not impaired, something like that. This is a word I've never heard of them use before, but I guess that's been used in the past before too with Jeff Hardy, but I digress. So WWE decided, suggest him to go to rehab. And Jeff Hardy refused. And if Jeff Hardy knew they were gonna fire him, because they did the first time they did with him. Obviously Justin Dree, where he refused at first. Because he was fucked up during that time. And they released him. It was basically all their hands. If he doesn't want to go, then let him go. He's not our problem no more. Same thing happened with Umaga. Umaga refused to go to rehab back in 2009. So, he's out of our hands. Let him go. He's not our problem anymore. And we all know what happened months later with him. His he unfortunately died. So hopefully with Jeff Hardy, thank God that Jeff Hardy's still here, and we're tasting what's going on from now. That was gonna be the case at all. So basically WWE jumped to conclusions, that kind of hurts to say, they jumped the gun by firing Jeff Hardy, not knowing that if he was either drunk while wrestling or he relapsed, that wasn't the case at all. Because as we saw on the video with Matt Hardy, Jeff Hardy was fine, in the ring with the kids, and they talk about he's gonna be on tour with his Jeff Hardy music and all that. Like, yeah, Jeff Hardy's fine. What the fuck?
Maybe
out of nowhere.
Maybe he just made it all up, or like he didn't want to take rehab because it was a plan to leave the company because of the bullshit.
Yeah, if Jeff Hardy fucking walk it out, he did exactly what people should do when they're watching Monday Night Raw. He walked out and said, "Fuck this shit, man. I'm done." Honestly, this man doesn't even. I know people say they want him in All Elite. Not right now. Honestly, Jeff needs to take fucking time to himself. He needs to take time for himself, and spend time with his family, and just think. Wrestling's the last fucking thing he needs right now.
Yeah. Eventually, he will go to AEW, but he needs to clear his head after that incident, because. You don't just leave a company like that after you went on the Broken Skull section saying that, this is my last chance to make things right, he can't screw up this time. Well, based on what you did there, you kind of did screw up because you ended up being fired from one of the biggest companies. But you're just gonna be in a huge push to go up against Roman Reigns, which I'm assuming he's gonna win the Rumble, Jeff Hardy, and go to WrestleMania to face Roman Reigns for the title. But now all plans change because of that now, because now they're going to go a different direction. Which, it's going to be something that WWE's that do something with tends to push in new guys, which, they've been failing to do that all these years. So, in a way, they got to find someone new to face Roman Reigns at WrestleMania. And we'll see where they go from there, but I doubt that. They don't want anyone to be bigger than the WWE, because, Oh, we can't allow that. We can't have that. We gotta stop this. Why? You're gonna continue to lose more viewers, and no one's showing up anymore to your events. As you can see, a lot of all these arenas that they go to, all the seats are being torn off. Meanwhile, we see AEW crowds, in the arenas, jam packed.
That is very, very true.
That's what I like.
Don't you like seeing those half arenas from WWE and shit, and they always show the other half, and it's like there's nobody there?
I think it's funny.
Like, half the arenas fucking gone. We've got 60,000 fans here. Reality sets in. We've got 20,000. We sold out the whole Raw arena. 400 seats.
Now I know they can sell Royal Rumble. They can sell WrestleMania, just like they sell SummerSlam.
Oh yeah, WrestleMania and Royal Rumble is automatically sold out because of what they are. Because it's like tradition. A tradition with people. They got to.
Yeah. Survivor Series though, that didn't pack up at all.
Survivor Series has gotten fucking stale.
It has.
Honestly, if we don't get the debut, if we need to finally get the debut of Eggman.
Eggman.
Yeah. Come on, Mark. You got any work to do lately?
Man, I think that's still that's still a long time ago.
It's Far Cry from the Survivor Series pay per views from the 2000s.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's the what the Survivor Series now. Nah, it's just all shit. And it's like fuck Elimination Chamber too. I don't even want to watch that shit with a padded fucking chamber.
They ain't worn that down.
Yeah, they have. They fucked up everything. I'm sorry, but Elimination Chamber and Hell in the Cell do not need their own themed pay per views. No, they are made to be one match at a pay per view.
Yep. It's what it's called for. Not for we got pay per view called Hell in the Cell. We gotta have Hell in the Cell. No. It doesn't work that way.
Yeah, just
I can't remember the last time I got into an Elimination Chamber match.
Yeah.
Let's get Hell in the Basement. Every time I watch Raw, that's my Survivor Series. I gotta survive that shit.
Yeah, for those who watches, yeah. But yeah, Jeff Hardy, hey, he's just doing fine. He's all right. He's doing good, and I bet you he will go to AEW. When that will be, don't know. But again,
go back to Impact. We need the return of Willow.
Well, yeah, he could do that too.
You could get that in AEW.
I mean, yeah, you could do that AEW too. Yeah.
No, because AEW, we need buckwheat.
Oh. Oh wait, that was a missed opportunity. WWE. They have Buckwheat and Matt Riddle on to do a segment.
That would
have been fucking stupid.
Come on, yeah, because Itchy is all about weed and Matt Riddle.
Hell no.
It could do something with that.
Oh man, bro. What's going on? Ooh, yeah. What? What the fuck? Bro, you're not on weed. You're on coke.
Yeah, RVD comes out there with dude.
Yeah, he RVD because he's a Hall of Famer. He's with the company after all.
God, RV weed coming out. Yeah, DDP yoga, man. Whoa, gonna go fucking do some RV weed up my girl's big ass butt cheeks.
But yeah, it's whatever. Hey, we'll see what happens with Jeff Hardy in the future. As far as his band, hey, go for you, man. Yo. At the end of the day, he's got one thing to keep him stress free, and that's his music. Never wrong with that. So now, I can't believe we're saving that for last. But Kevin Owens decided to resign with the company for $2 or $3 million.
Kevin,
you're a fucking idiot.
Now his
reasoning, I just had to do it. Because you gave me some money, and I never watched WCW.
Yeah, even though that's fucking bullshit. Like, I understand if you didn't watch WCW, but you gotta have your wrestling magazines to know what's going on with your other companies.
No, only Divas magazines and WBF magazine. No WCW.
Or at least this was on your hotlines at the time as well.
Nope. Only WBF, Stone Cold, Rock. That's all I know. Because I'm like everybody else. That's all I know. Austin Rock. That's all I know.
Now, I thought that was weird when Kurt Owens said that.
Attitude Era is the only thing that existed. Don't know what WCW or ECW was.
Oh, God. But that was weird, though. Because, Kevin Owens got in the ring with Goldberg. I was thinking to myself, well, if you said that you never heard these guys before, and he ended up being in the ring with Goldberg, then you must know that who he was and why he was a big deal.
Yeah, you watched WCW back in the day. Get the fuck out of here, Owen.
Yeah, seriously.
Oh, I didn't know who the Warrior was. I knew who the Renegade was.
Come on, that's ridiculous. It's like saying me. I only watch WWF and never watched WCW or any other wrestling things.
That's like saying I know who The Weeknd is, but not Michael Jackson. What?
Oh God! Or Justin Bieber.
Oh God!
Oh God! Fuck Hook. I mean, fuck him.
What? Come on! Send Hook.
Send nope.
But anyway,
never heard of her.
Hook is going to be returning on Rampage this week, so can't wait for that.
Oh good, I can skip that episode.
Oh, come on. I don't remember who's going to wrestle, though, but the part of mine is later on.
Who cares?
Yeah. I know you don't. but, oh, yeah, so, yeah, Kevin Owens. So he resigns because, you know, he did it for his family. No, he did it for the money. Because, you know,
I mean, don't they all? Don't they fucking all?
Yeah, they
all. You know what? Yeah. Treat me like shit, but as long as you give me a fucking paycheck and some Titus Catering, we're good.
Yeah. So, I remember we talked about this before with Kevin Owens of his net worth of WWE, you know, his salary, whatever. It was like about 1.5 million they got. It was way more than what Dolph Ziggler is getting. Now he's got more than Dolph Ziggler now, because he's getting about $3 million now, multi-year deal with WWE right now. Still not more than The Miz, because you know, I think he, you know, Kevin Owens is worth more than Miz and Ziggler combined. But the fact you give him this much, even though you're making so much money, but you know, but we can, because you know, you're still having budget cuts issues, which is fucking bullshit.
So let me get this straight. You got budget cuts with all these other assholes, but we can give Kevin Owens $3 million a year. What's wrong with this picture?
But for his family. Even though Bray Wyatt, you know, he's got family.
The fucking real one needs $10 million a year because he's the shit.
Oh god! But he's got no kids.
He's doing. I got kids.
maybe some of y'all know of.
Oh fuck, kids!
oh god. But that's basically Kevin Owens' reasons, and because of that, now he's you know, I mean, he was getting you know, being pushed on TV before he decided to make his decision, or chance him being in the top picture now. Does that mean you know him resigning? He's going to win the belt? No. And once he loses, he's gonna be doing the same thing that WWE's gonna be doing from all year. He's nothing. Like he has no value because he's a pro wrestler who came from the indies.
That's what I was gonna say. I hear he's got a WWE title match coming up. He's probably gonna lose that, and he's probably gonna be stepped back in the mid card.
Yeah, guarantee he's going to be the one to get paid.
Hey, you know what? I don't feel sorry because you fucking signed right back with him, asshole.
Yeah.
Like, seriously, I guarantee he's going to be the one that's going to get pinned. Now, by who? Is going to be Seth Rollins? No, I don't think Seth's going to win. Is it going to be Big E to retain? I don't think he's going to retain. I think he's
going to go to Seth is too busy getting pinned by fans.
Maybe. I think they got Big E lose here.
Doesn't matter. If Kevin Owens gets the pin, hey man, don't bitch and say they treat me like shit, motherfucker. You re-signed. That's all I can say. You can bitch all you want, but that's on you, man. That's on you. Besides, you're getting money, so shout out to stop bitching.
Yep. Add that. You know, you want to make money for your, to park for your family, right? Great. Mm-hmm. Good for you. Good for you. I can't be mad at that.
Kevin Owens is like, I'm going to bring my family here, and we're going to be the new Team Canada.
Oh, no.
But is it worth it for you for your character to be directionless after you lose this, you know, at day one, which I'm pretty sure he's going to lose to Bobby Lashley, which is going to wait to be, you know, to protect Big E of his failed title reign as WWE champion, to put the belt back on Bobby Lashley?
Well, you know, he's going to be like, well, at least my gimmick is as bad as one of the wolves thinking he's Sandman.
Right. And there's rumors that Sami Zayn is going to resign with, you know, too, because, you know, his best friend signed with re-signed with WWE.
Who gives a fuck? Fuck Sami Zayn. Jesus Christ, man. That motherfucker. Fuck him, honestly. He just looks like a hobo cab driver. There's nothing to him.
Yeah, and he's got a conspiracy theory too, though.
Who gives a shit? That motherfucker's always been the most boring motherfucker. Never gave a rat's ass about Sami Zayn. Never gave a fuck about him.
Yep, and that's why he's in the position he's going to be in right now.
Wearing that dollar store under the giant mask, fuck him.
Oh god. But even if he does resign, he's not going anywhere either. You know, he's going to be in the same position that he's been before too.
Yeah, fuck Sami Zayn.
Yeah. And but as far as Kevin Owens, yeah, if you lose, you know, at day one and you like a directionless, you're in catering, eating Titus O'Neil's food and all that, and not being pushed on TV.
You know, is Titus still working for WWE?
Yes.
You know how much of a slap in the face that is to release all those great talents, but you keep Titus?
Yeah, because he's an ambassador.
Yeah, Vince is like, well, I got to have somebody clean my toilets.
Oh, God. So, yeah, Kevin Owens, I don't see him going anywhere. Yo, I don't think yo, they're going to do anything significant with him. Yo, now that he's signed. It's just him that came away from AEW. And they do him this much money, even though budget cuts. But we'll see.
That's because Vince is like, I already lost CM Punk and fucking Daniel Bryan to AEW. Like, those are some big damn losses for me.
Yeah, even Adam Cole.
Well, I didn't care about Mitch and Big Cass, but you know, those other ones.
But yeah, we'll see what happens with Kevin Owens to move forward. I mean, obviously, we're not going to watch to see, but I'm pretty sure some of us will. But yeah, it's going to be the same. It's the same position he's going to be in. Yeah, all year. I mean, you could have left Kevin Owens, you know, and come back against Kevin Steen. For you being a big Owen Hart fan, who's one of your all-time favorites, you could have been the guy that could have been in that tournament and won it, you know, for AEW. But nope, you said this day. You're going to stay with a company that can't honor Owen Hart. But you're not going to go to a company that is going to own, you know, it's going to honor Owen Hart. Yeah, that what logic sense that makes, yo, KO.
True. Yeah, but hey, KO, you want to stay there and be a bitch? Be a bitch. Oh, hey, I've got $3 million a year. That's nice, you fucking idiot.
Avoid that money because it's not worth it.
It's okay. We'll just make him be the first white member of New Day.
Oh, God.
Wait, yeah, he actually was, actually. The big
yep,
old.
Yeah, it'll be the new KO and shit, unicorn style.
Yeah, I'm not kidding you, folks. If you remember, he was called the big old.
Yep, the big old.
That is the dumbest shit I've ever heard.
Hey,
dude, that sounds like some fucking weird special in the McDonald's menu, the big O.
Well, Kenny Big was some Big Bob.
So, he's a Big Bob, the big Oreo? What the fuck?
Oh, man.
Yeah, I make girls get to the big ol'. We get a wrestler called the Big Fries.
Big Fries, yeah.
Yeah. The big motherfucker.
Still waiting on Nakamura to see what he's going to do.
He said he was gonna go to GFW, but it was too late.
GFW.
Oh, that's not all elite.
I don't think that's around anymore.
Well, if he goes to AEW, he's gonna lose his stature because everybody that goes to AEW, they're just not the same.
Whatever.
Well, like Shinsuke has lost his stature. Right, like because Shinsuke hasn't lost his stature at this point, right?
By the way, I would love your AEW would do a statue of Owen Hart.
I mean, shit, I thought fucking Braun Strowman was at least going to go to Impact. He went to ROH. I was shocked.
Oh, yeah, we'll talk a little bit about that, too. Barry Fisher,
you doing Dynamite? Imagine Shinsuke say that shit. Oh, I go to ROH. Yeah, you know what? Honestly, Shinsuke, anything's better than fucking women's wrestling entertainment.
Yeah, because Nakamura, even though he's Intercontinental Champion, they're not doing anything with him as Intercontinental Champion.
I'd rather he go back to fucking New Japan than fucking We Were Entertainment.
Exactly. Because him being Intercontinental Champion, not everyone, you know, some people will forget that. Wait a minute, he's Intercontinental Champion? Oh my God, I think he's Intercontinental Champion. Exactly, because they haven't done anything with him as Intercontinental Champion.
Oh, yeah. Like, who's Intercontinental Champion? I think it's an Asian dude that wears that Michael Jackson shit. I don't know. He's either that or I think it's like AJ's bodyguard. I don't know.
I think it's great.
He's got who's the last Intercontinental champion? What was that? Zack Ryder?
That was Apollo Crews, and he's not either.
Oh, but I'm sorry, but Apollo Crews was never going to be a big name. He just wasn't. No. He was just so, like, I'm not, no, I don't think he's black. No, nothing to do with black. He's just blah.
No.
He's just fucking blah. He smiles too much. He has no gimmick. It's just, I'm sorry, but when you got too many dudes walking around with just no gimmick at all, what is he going to, what is he? Like, what is he going to do?
Yeah, like, Rick a bitch.
You know, Finn Balor has something. You know, Prince debit card.
Oh, even Finn Balor, man, he came back to the main roster and now he's on Blend again. Like, what the fuck are you doing with it? What are you doing?
Back to smiling and shit.
Well, I mean, you know, you're not gonna get the demon character too much because that is one hell of a damn paint job you got to do. But
oh, that killed that character of the team rules the way he lost.
Oh, of course. Yep. That was the so demon stupid. Now.
Oh, I'm on the top rope. Oh, I slipped. The rope broke. I'm too heavy.
Oh, so basically they had the same shit that happened to the dude from AEW with the baby oil on the ropes. Yep. Oh, so Mr. Oily was over there too when he was making other people fall in WWE. Damn him.
Oh, so stupid.
Well, the demon that can't fly. Yeah, that's a damn shame.
Ridiculous. And that was the way to protect the demon. They thought that was a good idea to protect the demon.
No, the only way to protect the demon is they should have him lose to Cena. That always protects everybody.
Oh, God.
Oh, no. I lose to Triple H.
Oh, no.
You either get the golden shovel or the never give up. Which one's worse?
Never give up.
Well, I don't know. One, you both had terrible movies, Chaperone and Marine. Jesus.
Well, at least with Cena, he elevates people, right?
What?
No. To what?
That's the argument that people always make. You know,
look at everybody that Cena's faced. You know, they're all great. Half of the people that he's faced and he's beaten or whatever aren't even around anymore. So what does that tell you?
Yeah, these guys that's the argument that people will make. You know, Cena elevated them.
Well, he elevated Ray Wyatt by losing that little weird fantasy match against him at WrestleMania. Yeah, that worked out for Bray. Yeah, he's not employed anymore.
Yeah,
that was not really a match.
The one thing that Triple H tries to do well is he tries to sell anger. That's it.
Yeah.
You guys remember the core? Neither do I.
The core.
Oh, God.
Oh, man, the core.
The core. The core.
The core.
Dallas Store Nexus.
That's how Wayne Barrett says, by the way, because you know his accent. The call.
The call.
The call. The what? The claw? What the fuck?
That's another guy he buried. Wayne Barrett.
Yeah.
Oh, I've got some bad news for you. GFW is coming back.
Oh no.
Oh cool. Are you gonna be a commentator?
No. The bad news is I'm getting a sex change.
Oh.
like I'm going to be one ugly Barrett.
Like I taught it right.
And then when the dick comes out, it goes, boom, hammer.
Yeah.
Boom. I've got some bad news for you. Cena's getting another title reign.
No.
And then I've got some good news for you. There's going to be a marathon of Charlotte. So, Jalen, turn your TV on.
Yeah.
You were going to ask me something, Robert?
Oh, yeah. Are you going to do Dynamite later?
No. Unfortunately.
I've got more bad news. I'm going to wrestle again.
Just hope you get hurt again.
No. Because my apple pad turns into the red apple pad and I go, BOW, Emma!
Yeah, I'll be babysitting tonight, so I won't be able to do it.
That's bad news right there.
So maybe Otaku or CJ might do it. We'll see.
Yeah. That's some good news.
Yeah, it is.
Who the fuck's gonna do the AEW Dynamite review tonight?
Either CJ or Otaku.
I hope it's not Lance Storm.
Lance Storm?
Oh, and fuck Raven!
Nevermore.
Alright guys, so that's it for Asylum. 248.
Yeah, 240, boom!
And fuck Tom Holland.
Yeah.
Yeah. I've got some bad news for you. He's going to be doing more Spider-Man movies.
Oh. Well, let's see if he does better this, a job this time.
And I've got more bad news. Toby's not going to do DDP yoga.
Oh.
Yeah, oh. Fuck you. Fuck!
Right, so.
I've got herpes.
What?
What?
What? Yeah, herpes. I'm a Merry Christmas nuts. I haven't had my cock sucked in a long time.
By the way, the next time we do this,
I've got some bad news. I've got nobody for this prostitute.
Oh.
Hope I can sell some Booker teacups on the side.
Yeah, and finally, there's a Booker teacups. But by the way, I was going to say, the next time we do a sound show, yeah, one of the topics that we're going to do is going to be about the Home Alone called Home Sweet Home Alone.
Oh, fuck that movie!
Oh, I got a lot to say about that, by the way. We'll
that's bad news written all over that.
Yeah, I got something to say about that movie, because I actually did watch it.
It's a stupid-ass movie. It's like it's about Braun Strowman's childhood.
But you'd be surprised what I'll say about the movie.
Nah, that movie sucked dick. That doesn't exist.
but stay tuned for that one on next time show.
No.
Alright. Thank you guys for tuning in. Hope you guys enjoyed the stream. See you next time.
Yeah. Oh.